Oi, top of the morning to you laddies. You were playing Danganronpa 2 here. My name is Zaksepticeye and we are in the middle of the trail. Hopefully you guys, who you think the killer's gonna be, let me know in the comment section below. And make sure you buy your Zaksepticeye merchandise, got my face on it, and get the emotes and all that shit. For a low price of $14.99, you can join my Patreon, where we play Five Nights at Freddy's. Alright, anyways, moving on. Now then, the trial has reached its climax. I would like to present the answer right here, right now. That'd save us some time. You're gonna spoil who the killer is? Aw, shit. Dude, we're spoiling. Spoilers inbound. Here we go. I never noticed, like, the cute little faces on the hearts.
Boop, boop, boop.
If I reveal who the, if I reveal the answer before everyone's ready, they'll all be shocked. That would be true. Could you imagine if you're playing, then Monokuma's like, hey guys, the killer is blank. Now have fun playing the rest of the game now you know the answer, dumbass. And he jumps back in. That'd be actually sick. I actually wish that they would do that. If they want to fill the players with despair, what if Danganronpa 4 came out, and as soon as you start new game, Monokuma walks up and tells you the plot twist at the end of the game. He says, there, now you know the answer, dumbass, have fun playing this 40-hour game. And he walks away, and then you're like, and you have to play the game. Dude, I would love that. I would love that shit. You just start Danganronpa 4, and he just tells you all the big twists at the beginning. He's like, hey, dumbass, this person is the killer. This is the 16th mystery student. This is the traitor. And there you go. All right, now have fun playing the game. And it's boring as shit now. You're just like, you can't unknow spoilers. You're fucked. You already bought the game. All right, anyways, here we go. You can't. That's a big no-no. But spoiling it right now is innovative. That's what I'm saying. He knows. See, Monokuma and I, Danganronpa 2, Monokuma and I get along real well. The club president and I are powerless against innovation. Who's the club president? So without further ado, the answer is... You can't! Everyone, please close your eyes and cover your ears. Come on, chat, close your eyes, cover your ears. Monokuma's about to tell us who the killer is.
Nanu.
I don't know what you're talking about, but somehow it feels wrong to me. Damn, the killer was Nanu. Nanu Stalin. Stalin wasn't even German, was he? I don't know shit about shit. Okay. And resume the trial. Case of Mahiru Kozumi. Oh shit, Monomi, dude? Let's fucking go. Dude, Monomi's heart is throbbing. Dude, this is the best song in the game. I don't care what anybody says, dude. Best song in the game. Whoever killed Mahiru, I'm gonna fucking kill you. Alright? I can't wait to watch you die. That was my red-haired normie girlfriend. You got it, Monomi-san. We will do our best. All right, shut up.
Well, now that we've decided to believe Hyoko, now what?
Look at Nagito! Dude, I love that. Everybody's like thinking, everybody's like normal and thinking, and Nagito's just like happy, just like, oh, I'm so glad. Because remember, Nagito was like, I really hope that the killer isn't Fuyuhiko. That'd be boring. Yeah. He's like, he was like, they're like, I don't think it's Fuyuhiko, we think it's Hyoko. He's like, oh, thank God. And then like, wait, somebody set up Hyoko, and Nagito like, this is just great. I love it. He loves it. Yeah, but Ibuki brings up a good point. So far, all we did was discover that in the Twilight Syndrome murder case, that all the Ibuki, Mikan, Hyoko, and Mahiru were all in the game, and that Fuyuhiko's sister was killed by Girl E. Girl E was later killed by Guy F. So, everybody thought that, wait a second, Fuyuhiko has the most reason to kill Mahiru because he beat the game and he discovered that Mahiru had a hand in murdering his sister. Maybe not directly, but she still covered up the evidence. So then Fuyuhiko would be like, oh shit, well fuck this bitch. She covered up evidence in the murder of my sister. Let's kill her. However, things were not adding up, and there was a lot more evidence pinning this on Hyoko, because there was the letter in the pocket, the gummy on the floor, the footprints. But we found out that the gummy and the letter were both fake planted pieces of evidence by a different person. Somebody else planted these things to make it look like it was Hyoko. They invited her to the beach house, chloroformed her, and threw her in the closet. So when she woke up, she would see Mahiru's body leaving footprints, and therefore trying to frame her. But who is doing all this? Let's find out.
If the killer was luring Hyoko into a trap,
it was the gummy? Yeah, could you imagine? While Hyoko's sleeping, the gummy bear gets up, walks up, picks up the bat, and goes, and goes back on the ground. Holy shit, dude. Fucking gummy.
No, it was probably the gummy.
What? You guys are right! Chiaki said the killer was the gummy.
Huh?
I'm so sick of this gummy. We've been hearing about this gummy for all the time. They're still talking about the gummy. This whole case is like revolving around this gummy.
Just as I thought.
Just as you thought?
If the killer planted evidence while Hyoko was there, she would have thrown it away if she found it.
Oh, shit. Chiaki brings up a good point. See, the gummy is actually important. Because they were like, okay, well, we found the gummy. We found the gummy on the floor, but Chiaki was like, "Hey Hyoko, when you woke up in the closet, was the gummy already there?" And Hyoko was like, "No." And Chiaki's like, "That makes sense, because if the killer really did plant that as evidence, why would they plant it beforehand, risking Hyoko seeing it and getting rid of it? That would delete the purpose of leaving fake evidence." But what that proves is After Hyoko woke up, saw Mahiru, and ran out of the beach house, the killer came back to the scene of the crime and planted the gummy, which is really risky. But Chet, the weird question is, how the fuck was the killer able to make it back to the beach house and escape without leaving any footprints at all? Yet Hyoko's footprints remained. That is the key that will solve this mystery. So we now know that the killer must have come back after Hyoko left the beach house. That narrows down the amount of suspects, but it also means how were they able to enter and leave this house without leaving evidence of them being present? It really all comes down to the secret of this gummy.
Which means the gummy was placed inside the closet after Hyoko fled from the beach house?
That's risky. But Chad, what about this? What if the killer didn't come back and then left? What if the killer was always there the whole time?
The killer returned to the scene of the crime?
Or they could have returned, I don't know.
They wouldn't have to do something.
Yeah, never mind.
As long as they hid somewhere within the beach house.
So the plot thickens. That means somebody killed Mahiru, hid there, waited for Hyoko to come out of the closet, waited for her to leave, and then left. Yeah, I like to think that Mahiru put fake blood on her head, laid there. Hyoko woke up, screamed and cried. Mahiru woke up, she's like, ha, got him. Then took the bat and went, and died. Dude, that's some Nagito fucking like levels of thinking there. What would Mahiru's motivation be? Like, nobody's gonna solve this one. Dude, if that was the solution, I would have turned off this game and sold it. Oh shit, because I was gonna be like, oh well, where's the only place they could have hid? The shower room. But Hyoko looked in the shower room and nobody was there. So where else could this person have hid? If Hyoko is in the closet and nobody was in the shower room, there are no other rooms.
Then does that mean the killer came back?
I wonder. At any rate, the solution to that problem is connected to what really happened. That's what I think.
Buckle up, because from this point on, this next final hour of the case is the best. So get ready. I want to play a new game. This is, oh dude, this is Logic Dive. This is the best minigame. Ready? Shh. I hear you want to play a new game, so we prepared the perfect product for you. You will dive into your own brain and logically discern the mysterious answer from several questions. It's called the logic dive. During the logic dive, you will control a version of yourself created from an image within your brain. Your task is to reach the goal. Okay, all of this is just fancy talk for, hey, you guys know those special levels in Sonic the Hedgehog? That's just this. Special Sonic levels. Hell yeah, dude. You hate this? This is my favorite thing, Epic Man. I can't believe you hate this. I wish this was in Danganronpa 1. I love this. It doesn't take. It only takes long if you suck. That just means you don't have enough logic to dive into. God, shut up. I know this. I know how to do this. Good luck, have fun. She's right. This may be a very important problem. So, now, Hajime is stumped. So he has to look deep inside of his subconscious to think of something to bring up. If the killer tampered with the evidence after Hyoko ran away from the beach house, when... So this is the answer we have to figure out, chat. When did the killer arrive and depart from the beach house? When did the killer get to the beach house and when did they leave? We have to find out that window of time. If we can nail that window of time, we can better understand who the killer could be. Think. It's like Jimmy Neutron Brain Blast, except it's playable. If I just focus, I'm sure I'll be able to find the answer. All right, let's Brain Blast it up. Oh boy, Logic Dive. I love this. Is Logic Dive in V3? Chat, somebody let me know, I don't know. But here we go. Oh, I love this. Sick, dude, it's just a fucking skateboard game. Eat my shit, SSX. Dude, this game's sick. I gotta focus. What time? I gotta focus here. How do you sick jump? Oh, that's break. Question one. All right, right there. When did the killer arrive at the beach house? Before Hyoko arrived. Because they killed Mahiru. No shit. Oh, no. They had to be there, so never mind. They didn't kill Mahiru until after Hyoko was knocked out. They arrived at the beach house before Hyoko because they had to be there to chloroform her when she arrived. That's what it is. Okay. Oh god, this is tough. Shit, fuck, damn it. This is actually tough on the hardest difficulty. Okay. When did the killer leave the beach house? After Hyoko left. Because they had to plant the gummy. So they arrived before her and then after she left. Woohoo! Look at this shit, dude! Hajime is shredding, bro. This is better than any Tony Hawk game, I'll tell you that shit right now. Oh, fuck. Question three. Shh. Where was the killer hiding when Hyoko was unconscious? Beach house. Why do we know it's not the beach? Because there was no footprints left. If they were on the beach when Hyoko left, she would have seen them. So they couldn't have been hiding on the beach because when Hyoko ran out, when you kick down the door of the beach house, all that's left is the open beach. There's nowhere to hide unless they were under the fucking water making bubbles. It's all coming together. Dude, Hajime's great.
Do you think the killer might have been hiding?
So, Hajime's like, the killer must have been hiding. The way that the window of time where they were there before Hyoko left, after Hyoko... They had to have been there the entire time. So now, if the killer was really there, that's almost creepy. I actually feel bad for poor little Hyoko right here. That means while she was unconscious with the gummy, the killer was in the same room as her, just like, or like the same beach house as her, waiting. Then she woke up, saw the body and left. The whole time the killer is in that house watching her. But where were they hiding? Bitch, we're trying to help you. You want me to accuse you of being the killer again?
Didn't I just say there was nowhere to hide? Do I have to explain it in another language so you can understand? Her personality got a hell of a lot more forceful once she stopped being a suspect.
Right, Ibuki?
No, there should have been a place for them to hide. A place you didn't look, Hyoko.
A place for the killer to hide. A place that Hyoko didn't look. Now Akane is gonna give us the Dekopine. I don't really want that to happen to me. I like how Hajime like thinks about it in his head. He's like, I don't want Akane to bop me on the head. Oh, God. All right, Chet. Where was the killer hiding? You want to riddle me that? If Hyoko looked in the shower room and there was nobody in the shower room, where the fuck did the killer hide? Isn't that the question of the day? There's a pretty open area. Hid in the flower pot? Where the hell could the killer have hid? Well, the only place, even if it doesn't make sense, the only place is the closet. But isn't that where Hyoko was hiding?
In the closet.
So was the killer inside the closet with unconscious Hyoko this entire time? This is kind of fucking creepy. This is kind of crazy.
After you woke up, you said you rushed out of it, right?
Correct.
And you probably didn't look inside the closet very carefully.
But could two people even hide in such a small place and without Hyoko knowing?
Yeah, how could somebody have hidden there without Hyoko even noticing? Killer made sure to arrange a hiding place in advance. I can only think of one place. That's right. The place where the killer was hiding inside the closet. Where is that? If Hyoko was right there on the floor next to the yellow gummy, where the hell could the killer even hide here? Where? How? Hyoko, a little girl body, was stuffed right here. So where the fuck could the killer possibly be? So a very packed, full closet. Remember when we were investigating the closet, Hajime made a strange observation. He talked about the size of the surfboard cases and how... What? I ran out of time? Are you fucking me in the ass? There's a time limit, you know. Even F-Zeros run hot during time attack. What? Chiaki, give me a second, girl. No, I didn't make a fool of myself. It was in the surfboard. Right, in the surfboard case, he talked about how it was weird that the surfboard case was empty. What is that? Is it this one? Yeah! That means the killer was laying in the surfboard case?
The surfboard case in the closet. I'm pretty sure they could have hidden in there.
It's the only place that makes sense.
Huh? Inside the surfboard case?
Damn, Hyoko, like, what?
But the shelf, it was
there was a gummy in there, too?
It was pretty messy, don't you think? Surfboards were stacked on the top shelf, and there were surfboards that weren't even in a case.
Exactly, there was an empty case.
The killer probably did that on purpose to secure a hiding place, because we haven't been on this island that long.
This is a crazy complicated case. Like, forging the notes, getting Hyoko and Mahiru there, all this shit, you know, hiding in the surfboard, trying to frame, you know. Correct me if I'm wrong. No, I was gonna say, correct me if I'm wrong, but is this the first case where the killer did a lot of effort to frame somebody else? But I lied. In case 3 of Danganronpa 1, Celeste did a hell of a lot to try to frame Yasuhiro. But I actually think that this was better, like, more well done than that.
Then the killer was close to me during that time?
I know, dude. Could you imagine, like, finding out? That'd be like if you were sleeping and you woke up and there was a dead body on your floor and you freaked out, left the room, and then called the police later to find out that when you woke up, the killer was still in your closet. Holy shit, that's unnerving.
Yeah, they were quietly holding their breath and hiding very close to you.
Oh shit, it was the bald gray man all along. Holy shit, look at him. Hyoko's like, pass the fuck out, dude. Sure, I don't know what that means.
But don't you mean it's always darkest under the lighthouse?
What are all these sayings I've never heard of?
I shouldn't say things I don't understand, like, so to speak.
That'd be really scary.
Anyway, the killer hid silently, and after making sure Hyoko left, they finally left the circle.
One another reason why Code Geass is my favorite anime of all time, the main character, Lelouch, has the same voice as Hajime. No shit. I have a feeling that Nagito knows who the killer is this whole time. Maybe I'm wrong, I don't know. Maybe he figured out more than we have, but he seems to, like, have already known everything that we know.
Seriously, nobody asked what you think.
Damn, Akane.
There's no way the killer would leave Hyoko by herself if they were trying to frame her. If Hyoko was left alone and ruined the evidence the killer had planted, it would have messed up their plan.
So they had to stay in the room to make sure that Hyoko didn't mess up the evidence. It's good, Epic Man, but it's funny that you say that, though, because, like, my favorite voice out of all the characters in Japanese is actually Nagito's. I love it. And that's why that song, like, when I heard that song and, like, it's sung by Nagito's voice, I was just like, holy shit. And just so you guys know, that's not a spoiler. In the anime Danganronpa 3, it's just a reference. It's not a spoiler to anything. But there's a song that plays, because you know how animes have openings and outros? There's an outro to one of the arcs in the Danganronpa 3 anime, and it's sung by the same person that voices Nagito's voice, so you're just like, oh my god. You recognize the voice immediately, and it's just a really cool, like, reference, and you get to hear the voice. And the song's called Hope's Birthday. Like, the song's called Hope's Birthday, and the song's, like, all about, like, believing in hope, and it's just like, holy shit.
Say whatever you want, even if you didn't ask. Alright, if you don't want to friggin' get punched, just stand still and let me punch ya!
What? That doesn't make any sense! If you don't want to get punched, stand still and let me punch ya? And even Nagito's like, he doesn't know how to comprehend that one.
Oh, you shut up, then grit your teeth.
Am I weird for wanting Akane and Nagito to fight?
Sorry, Akane. It's not like that.
Uh-oh.
Hey, Monokuma. Can I ask you about something that seems strange to me?
Oh, shit! I forgot about this part! There is something about this trial. I forgot who brought it up. There's something about this trial that, soon as we started the investigation, I think it was maybe Edwards? I don't remember. Soon as I started this trial, somebody brought up that there was something very weird that happened. And this whole time, nobody's brought it up. Until right now. There was something from the moment we discovered Mahiru's body that we thought was very freaking weird. And nobody brought it up. Somebody in the chat did. Let's find out. What's up, Nagito? What do you want to ask Monokuma?
I believe Prince Shotoku was from the future.
Nagito's going to bring this up.
The future is always directing the flow of history.
Chat brought it up.
I'll listen to your story about men from the future some other time. As I recall, the body discovery announcement is made when three or more people discover a body, right? Is the killer also included among those three or more people?
So, the body discovery announcement plays once three or more people have discovered the body. That means if one person discovers the body, nothing. A second person discovers the body, nothing. It's only until three or more people have seen the victim's corpse that Monokuma plays that announcement. Now, if we can remember, Nagito is bringing up a good point. He's like, is the killer included? Because that makes a world of difference. Because what happens? Remember we were walking because remember how good everything was up until Mahiru was killed? All the girls had their swimsuits on. We were all going to, like, play. Remember Chiaki brought ice cream and board games. We were all going to go swimming and everything was good. And remember on our way to the beach house, Hajime's walking. And before he gets in the house, he hears a body has been discovered. And Hajime's like, wait, what? What the fuck? So he runs and breaks down the door. And who's in the room? Just him and Kazuichi. So there was two people in the house and Mahiru's body. That means before Kazuichi and Hajime entered that beach house, somebody else would have had to have seen the body first. And that's why that makes a world of difference. Because if the killer's included, then we can erase all that. We'd be like, oh, well, the killer was the first person to see the body, then Kazuichi, then Hajime. But if the killer is not included, that means somebody killed Mahiru, somebody else discovered the body, then it was Kazuichi, Hajime wasn't even included, my bad. The announcement played before Hajime got there. So, sorry, forget what I said. I misspoke. Ignore Hajime. That means Hajime would have been the fourth person to see it. So we already knew the first two. It was, if it is the killer, it would be the killer killed Mahiru. They saw Mahiru's body. Then Hyoko, when she woke up from the closet. Then Kazuichi. But if the killer's not included, that means it was the killer, Hyoko, Kazuichi, and somebody else. So this actually makes a world of difference, whether the killer is included or not. So let's see what Monokuma says. Yeah, I'm sorry, Harper. I misspoke. I forgot that the announcement played. Hajime was not a part of that equation at all. Ignore everything I said about Hajime, because the announcement played before Hajime ever even entered the house. Because when he heard the announcement, he was already freaking out, like, wait, what? What's going on? And then he didn't see who the victim was till after he rushed in the beach house.
You don't sound very articulate.
I like this. Again, I think this is why people like Nagito so much, because, like, he actually, like, this is the second time now that he's, like, gotten Monokuma to slip up. So he's almost like smarter than Monokuma at moments. Look at this. Who in Danganronpa 1 would make this happen besides Makoto at the very end of the game?
Jeez, you're pretty annoying for noticing something like that. I know it sounds like an excuse, but the body discovery announcement isn't supposed to be used for deduction. It's intended to create a fair trial. It's supposed to let everyone know a body has been found.
So you're saying it's unfortunate that I used it for deduction? I understand your excuse, but depending on who actually found the body, it's possible that your three or more people rule could be deadly.
That could make or break the case.
Well, as long as I keep things ambiguous, I can respond to situations with some flexibility.
Flexibility? So what about this time? Is it three people including the killer or not?
I'm on the edge of my seat, Monokuma. What's he gonna say? Alright.
You want me to say it? It doesn't include the killer this time, okay? All done.
It wasn't even Sunday stream either. Alright, anyways. So listen, Monokuma says, you want me to say it? It does not include the killer this time. So that is interesting. That means not ignoring the killer, literally ignoring the killer, three other people saw Mahiru's body.
Which means three people other than the killer discovered Mahiru's body.
Couldn't have said it better myself, Nagito.
What's wrong with that?
Hajime doesn't even understand. Nagito is such a dick. Like, obviously it means something, but instead of trying to help them out, he just gives them, like, clues. Because he's, like, neutral. He's a psychopath.
You're the one who went on a tangent.
We were just saying the killer was hiding in the surfboard case, right?
True, true.
And after Hyoko ran away, the killer got to enjoy the simple life of destroying evidence.
However, before we proceed any further, there's something we have to make clear. The killer blocked the roadside door with Mahiru's body before Hyoko ran away. But what about the blood?
That is true. That is also a very true statement. So, yeah, Gundam's cool. But that means the killer smashed Mahiru, hid in the surfboard, and then they had to prop up Mahiru's, before they hit in the surfboard, they had to prop up Mahiru's body against the door. How the fuck did they not get any blood on them? Remember, we found out that it wasn't, because everybody was like, how come Hyoko would have blood? And then Fuyuhiko was like, well, what if Hyoko took all of her clothes off, moved Mahiru, and then put all of her clothes back on? And then they're like, well, she can't get dressed by herself, so we know it's not her. But then, whoever the real killer is, wouldn't they have blood on them? Or did they? If they picked up Mahiru's bloody body and moved it against the door, they'd have to have blood on them.
Now that you mention it, The mystery hasn't been solved yet.
It's going to be all right. If you guys have come this far, I'm sure you can discover that answer too.
See, the way he words that, it makes you think that he already knows the answer. What does he know?
Now, let's start the argument.
He loves this. He loves this. He was born for this fucking shit to happen to him. I don't care what anybody says. Nagito waited for this fucking moment in his life. For the time he was born, he was bred for this fucking killing game. Alright, that's the same as Danganronpa 1. The truth flashback shit. I'm familiar with that. Here we go. That's his Hellhound earring. It can destroy worlds. We have one bullet.
What did the killer do with the blood on their body?
Maybe they simply washed it off.
They couldn't use the shower, right?
That's true. They couldn't use the shower.
So washing it off would have been impossible.
They didn't have to use the shower.
Thanks, Parks.
What about the wetsuits in the closet? Maybe they wore one when they moved the body. If they used something other than the shower, what did they do with the bloody wetsuit?
Yeah, that's true.
They cut it up and flush.
What does that even mean?
Someone who flushes their shit every morning, I can declare, they would definitely clog the toilet.
He's like, hey, I would know that if they use a wetsuit, it would clog the toilet. Oh my god, this song is so fucking good. Can we turn this shit up, please? Why is this like the best banger ever? Alright, here we go. Shh. Get the focus.
Maybe they were able to wash it off.
I don't know, guys. But wouldn't there still be blood on it? How would Sonya have washed the blood off? If the shower was broken.
What did the killer do with the blood on their body?
Just wondering. Here we go. But listen.
Maybe they simply
we have to figure out how they got rid of the blood. That's all that that matters right now. Shower, how did they get rid of the blood? How in the world did they get rid of the blood?
Washing it off would have been impossible.
They didn't have to use the shower.
It doesn't. It's not impossible. Washing it off wasn't impossible. What other way could
they
have done?
Did they use something other than the shower?
Other than the shower has to be.
What did they do with the bloody wetsuit?
The fact that they could have used something other than the shower means it's not impossible.
As someone who flushes their shit every morning, I can declare it would definitely clog the toilet.
Alright, here we go.
Perhaps someone other than the killer moved the body? Maybe they were able to wash it off.
If I use that person's opinion, I might be able to break through the contradiction. Let's see.
What did the killer do with the blood on their body?
Maybe they simply washed it off.
They couldn't use the shower, right? So washing it off would have been impossible.
Not impossible!
No, that's wrong!
I don't know, man. Fuyuhiko has been acting weird. Fuyuhiko has been acting real weird. He always wants to, like, sweep everything under the rug. Right.
They could have just as easily used something else.
How else could they have washed the blood off?
Something other than the shower. Like what?
Something other than the shower that was used to wash off the blood. Remember, Chet, when we did our investigation? After we found the body, we noticed that all of the non-sugared drinks were not only taken from the fridge, but the empty bottles were thrown in the trash.
I see. Drinks inside the refrigerator.
Do you guys remember that? Do you guys remember how there was a garbage can full of empty bottles? Remember? So when we were investigating, Kazuichi was just like, hey, Hajime, I remember there being a lot more drinks in the fridge. And then Hajime's like, yeah, it seems like the only things left are sugar drinks or drinks that have colored dyes in them. That's what Hajime said, and then they brushed it off and started investigating the body. But I could understand if one or two bottles were missing. Why would all, literally all of the waters go missing, leaving all of the sugar drinks and then all the empty bottles of water be inside the trash can? So what they're saying is, yes, the shower was broken, but after they moved Mahiru's dead body to get the blood off of them, they took all the water bottles out of the fridge and washed themselves off with the water bottles in the shower. Therefore, the blood would still run down the drain, they'd clean themselves off, and they would dispose of the water bottles in the garbage. What? Pekko says no? Never mind, I guess, fuck me. No, not another sword fight. Oh, fuck. She's the ultimate swordswoman, too, and now I gotta counter this? In theory, that's impossible. Why? Yeah, thank you, Hajime. Why is that impossible?
Try to remember the refrigerator carefully, and then you will understand.
Okay.
That there's no possible way the drinks in the refrigerator were used.
What? Why does she think that there's no way the drinks were used? What? I don't fucking know, dude. What the fuck? I don't know. I have no idea, dude. The tone in Pekko's voice, so threatening, it might cut me. We're nearing the moment when our fates will be decided. Why do you think it was only one bottle, though? Yeah, what she's saying makes sense. One bottle drink would be enough to wash off the blood, but why the fuck are you thinking that there was only one bottle used? That makes no sense.
It's true there were drinks in the beach house refrigerator.
Shit.
However, try thinking one bottle too wouldn't be enough to wash off the blood.
Holy shit.
It's true there were drinks in the beach house refrigerator. However, try thinking one bottle too wouldn't be enough to wash off the blood.
There we go. Holy. Oh shit. Whoa. Damn it, Pekko! Oh shit.
There were no water bottles in the refrigerator. There were only flavored drinks. If you use those to wash blood off, the blood will come off in your body.
What do you mean there's no bottles in the refrigerator? Dumbass, they were all in the trash can. Heathen, they're saying, because yes, the shower room is broken in the sense that the faucets don't work, but they're saying they could have still gone in the shower, poured the water on them to get the blood off, and then the blood would still run down the drain, leaving no puddle and no blood. They can still use the shower even if water doesn't come out of the faucet. That's what they're saying anyway.
There were no water bottles in the refrigerator. Allow me to cut through those words.
There were no bottles in the fridge because after they were used, they were thrown in the trash can. Idiot. No, you're good, dude. This is like a crazy mastermind plan, Heathen. Dude, do not feel stupid if you can't follow along. This is one of the best writing. This killer is like big brain.
How many times do I have to tell you? There are no water bottles in there whatsoever.
It's because they were in the trash can right to the left of it, if you would have looked. Damn, dude.
So you're saying the water bottles were gone because they were all used? That's a logical fallacy.
All right, buckle up. We're almost nearing the end here. We are going to get revenge on Mahiru.
It's not a fallacy. There should have been evidence inside the trash can.
Okay.
Evidence like a lot of thrown away plastic water bottles. Isn't that right, Chiaki?
Chiaki. Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Well, now that you mention it, when I went to the beach house a few days ago, I feel like I drank one of those plastic water bottles.
Okay, but like, in Kazuichi's defense, like, at the beginning, there's no way that you would know that that's important to the case. Like, of all the crazy things in this case, the water bottles were, like, so easily forgotten. You know, so a lot of people didn't even, like, consider that that was even important to this. Sorry, my hair is all fucked up in my eyeballs.
Then, the plastic water bottles were used in place of the shower.
Yeah.
Dousing your body with lots of water bottles is such a simple and easy to understand explanation.
Yeah, Buki. Look at Hajime's... What? Then Hajime... Oh, shit. Uh-oh, here we go. Oh, hold on a second. I have goosebumps on my fucking arm. Now that I think about it, if they soaked their entire body with a bunch of plastic water bottles, if they did that, then that person would be.
It seems you've realized who the killer is.
Oh! Nagito knew the whole time! Chat, believe it or not, Hajime just now realized who the killer is. Were you able to? Hajime had a revelation just now. And Nagito's like, oh, looks like you figured it out. If everything happened the way that we said it did, and the killer, it couldn't have been Akane, because I could understand why you'd think it's Akane, because she had blood on her, but Mikan checked her head and actually, you know, sewed up her head, and there was an actual wound with the blood dripping out, so it was not Mahiru's blood. When Sonia arrived and Chiaki arrived and everybody like arrived at the beach house, they were all dry. Sonia's hair was dry. None of them had gone swimming yet. However, there was somebody who arrived and was already wet. There's somebody. Hold on. You know who the killer is?
You know who the killer is?
Are we right, though? Who's to say that we're not missing something? Let's keep playing.
Let me ask. Who might that be?
If the killer used plastic water bottles to wash the blood that splattered onto them, then think about it. From the time Mahiru died to the time her body was discovered was a very short amount of time. It was like 30 minutes. So. Or less, I guess. Because they, you know, met up and stuff. All right, Chet. Again, if everybody was dry and nobody had blood on them, who's the only person... Remember, it was the gummy. It was Byakuya. Well, let's find out. Pekko, do you wanna? What do you think about this? I wanna see what she has. You're the only one. But let's see.
Pekko, is it you?
Accusing you of being the killer.
But Chet, that doesn't make any fucking sense. What the hell would Pekko's motive be? We played the Twilight Syndrome murder case game. Pekko had nothing to do with that. Not only was she not even one of the fucking characters in the game, she was not related to any of the victims, not related to anybody. So why in the absolute, if it was Pekko, what the fuck would that motivation be? Makes absolutely no sense.
Then I should ask you this.
Yeah. Of all the people?
I remember when we were all moving up to go to the beach. Your appearance when you came to the diner.
And remember, her excuse was, why was she wet? She said that she just got done swimming laps around the island. She was the only one that was just freshly wet. Doesn't that add a lot of, like, assuming that this is even true and not just another fucking false red herring, doesn't that change a lot? Remember, like, our mindset? We were just seeing all these cute girls and we're like, damn, Pekko looks so good. But if she was the killer, wouldn't that add like a lot more creepiness to it? We're like, oh, when we saw her and she was all dripping wet. What if she just got done killing Mahiru? What if she just got done washing the blood off after smashing that poor girl's brain in? Doesn't that add a lot to the context? Assuming that this is not all just one big fallacy. Kazuichi said, hey, aren't you breathing pretty heavily? I just did a little swimming.
If the killer really did wash the blood off with water bottles, they'd have to drench
It's true.
But there were no towels in the beach house, and it would have taken a while for the water to fully air dry.
No towels in the beach house, and it would have taken a bit for it to dry.
You said you went swimming so you'd have a cover story. Don't just stay silent. Say something. Hold on, you bastard. You saw her at the diner. You never saw her near the beach house, right?
Whoa. Okay, that's true.
So maybe she really was swimming. No one even saw her swimming. No, I saw her.
Well, shit, dude. Now she has an alibi. So fuck that. We were just wrong again. We were all wrong again. Fuyuhiko's like, what do you guys, are you guys fucking stupid? I literally saw her swimming. So she didn't use the bottles. What? Dude, how many times can we get tricked?
After I ran into you bastards at the diner, I crossed paths with her on my way home.
What if he's just trying to be a simp, dude? No, he would simp for Chiaki.
She would have arrived at the diner from the opposite direction of the beach house. Hold on. That's strange. Didn't you just say this earlier?
He said, hold on, this is strange. Didn't you say this earlier? Oh, that is true. Fuyuhiko earlier in the trial said, it's just a coincidence I passed by the diner. I didn't even pay attention to the beach house. But now he's saying that he saw her swimming at the beach house. And then he said he went straight back to the hotel. Why is he lying?
You told me you didn't see anyone. Don't try to tell me you forgot about
him. He did. He said he didn't see anybody. What? What the fuck?
Not so fast. It's too soon to decide she's a killer.
Holy shit.
We haven't established how the killer was able to leave the beach house.
You know what? As much as I dislike Fuyuhiko for being a piece of shit, he does bring up a good point. Let's just say, in theory, chat, just hypothetically, let's just say that Pekko is the killer. Let's say that Pekko killed Mahiru, washed off the blood with the water bottles. How the fuck did she leave the beach house and plant the gummy? Because then she'd also have to be the one that planted the gummy. How the fuck did she leave the beach house and not leave any footprints? That's another thing. How is it that Hyoko left footprints, but she didn't? How? You know, it doesn't make any sense. That's true. We can't find the killer until we can find out how the killer was able to leave the beach house in the first place.
The roadside door was blocked. And if it's impossible to leave from the beachside without leaving footprints...
That's true.
Then how the fuck did the killer escape?
This is so good. I love this trial so much. I love this trial. This is one of my favorites. Because it's just like, you're just like always lost. You're always lost.
Why are you all fired up, Fuyuhiko? You're not the suspect. Pekko is.
Yeah, Ibuki's like, why are you getting mad? We're not even suspecting you anymore.
Who cares about that? Answer me. If you have an explanation...
There's so much mysteries.
You might have an answer.
The best is yet to come. I don't know, Heathen, because think about this. Think about this, dude. If the killer gets away, if the killer gets away, all of the other students get killed. Does Fuyuhiko really seem like the type of guy to be like, yeah, I'll get fucking killed for some random hoe? He is the ultimate Yakuza. If he got out of here, he got all the girls he wished. He's a Yakuza master. Why would he randomly pick Pekko of all these people?
If Pekko is the killer, then I might just have an answer to that mystery. We'll see. Then let's hear this alleged method of escaping the beach house.
That is true. How could somebody have escaped the beach house?
Let's establish how the killer escaped.
The killer's escape route. I think I might know what it is. In fact, the only possible thing I can think of is that opening. Well, if it wasn't the door, it wasn't the front door, and it wasn't the side door, the only other way to leave the beach house is the small window in the shower room.
I see.
What's weird about that, though, chat?
Beachside and beachside doors aren't an option. The only other
another thing I can think. What's weird about that window? Why is that not likely? Or what's the difficulty in that? Yeah. Well, thank you, Harper. Nothing really. It's way too high. Akane had to piggyback on him just to reach it.
Huh. Don't you know how high that window is? There's no way Pecco could have reached it.
It's true. That's true, but what? What if somebody was an accomplice? What if somebody was an accomplice to the crime?
She might have reached it by riding someone's shoulders, but then that person would have been left behind.
Nope. Never mind. Dumbasses, you guys all thought that was smart. Akane just outsmarted you. That's true. If somebody piggybacks on somebody's shoulders and gets them out of the window, that person's still left in the beach house, so that's stupid.
Is it possible an object was used? A rope, for instance?
And what happened to the rope after they used it? And don't say something stupid like they threw it outside.
Yeah, they couldn't have used a rope. Idiot.
That would violate the
no littering. You can't litter. So couldn't have used a rope or a ladder. So how'd they reach the window? Littering is not allowed. Or Monokuma will kill you.
Littering is prohibited. Even if it might be evidence, rules are still rules.
But the thing, though, Harper, is like, the only way to reach that window is two people would have to stack on top of each other. The person that stacks would get out of the window, but how would the person on the bottom get back out? They couldn't reach from the top and pull them up. The person that piggybacked would still be stood there in the room not knowing how the hell to get out. There would still be somebody unaccounted for.
You see, there's no way they'd be able to escape from that window.
But wait, they could have used a rope if it wasn't for the no littering rule. So, how could they have used something to escape? How could they have used something to escape the room without getting rid of the evidence?
No, they just have to use an object.
Chiaki is saying they have to use an object to escape, but how'd they get rid of it?
Chiaki, don't fall asleep on us. We just said they couldn't use an object.
Chiaki didn't sleep this time.
I thought you were saying they couldn't dispose of an object.
That's true. They could use an object, but they couldn't dispose of an object. Now, why is that important?
I see. You don't have to throw it away if you can just hide it somewhere on your body.
If you can keep the object on you, then you don't need to dispose of it, do you?
Huh? Pecco was wearing a swimsuit, remember? Where would she even hide an object?
Yeah. How could she hide something if she's wearing a swimsuit?
And if you say she hid it in her special place, I'll stab you in yours!
Oh, God.
No! Please don't be violent!
Even if the killer used an object to escape from the window, they would not have been able to get rid of it. So the only thing I can think of is the killer must have hidden it somewhere. If that's the case... All right. How could the killer use an object, be able to hide it, but she was only wearing a swimsuit? Hangman's Gambit. I think you guys figured it out. What's the one thing that the ultimate swordswoman keeps on her at all times, and she had on her when she went to the diner? Her bamboo sword. A lot of bologna here. No! Fuck! Where are all the A's at, bro? I needed a letter A, my man. There we go. How the hell you spell bamboo around here? Sorry, my lighting equipment was like in the middle of the floorboard. I need another B. There we go. There we go. at this. Boom. Boom and boom. There we go. That's some good Hangman's Gambit right there. Woo! Oh my goodness, dude. My my throat is like...
That bamboo sword on your back at all times, right?
There we go.
If I recall correctly, you had it then too.
She even had it when she went to the diner. She had the bamboo sword on her, dude! Look at that shit! All these little things that you don't even realize? We still don't know the motive, though. This is bullshit.
Are you saying she used that bamboo sword to escape through the window?
Yeah. Heko used that bamboo sword as a step stone to escape out the window.
Yep. So, they're saying that all she had to do was prop the sword up against the wall, stand on the hilt, and use it to get out, which... if the sword is as tall as her, would be the height of two different people, allowing her to be able to get out. Very viable.
Sword as a step stool?
Damn, even Ibuki shocked this.
You see? I knew it. I knew it was a ninja. Didn't I tell you? A ninja could have climbed that easily.
Akane did call it. She's like, a ninja could get up there.
Ninjas know a climbing trick where they lean their sword against a wall and use the handguard as a step stool.
Damn, dude. Ancient ninja technique. That's how she did it.
Wow, just like a Japanese ninja.
Sonya, no, now's not the time.
Miss Sonya, ninjas only exist in Japan.
Well, it is a bamboo sword, but I'm sure a slender girl like Peko could easily use it to climb.
It's true.
Well, Peko, do you have anything to say?
Yeah. All right, Peko. What do you have to say to that? Because she was like, well... you have to prove how I was able to get out if you think I'm the killer. What do you have to say about that? There's me still, I have no motive. Why would she have done this? Oh god, we have to do this shit again? Okay. This shit's hard. We did this last trial. Taters! It's the end of the trial! We're about to find out who killed Mayu! You missed a lot. I don't know if you should be here right now. I don't know if you should be here. There's a lot of plot things. We're about to find out who the killer is. No, what? Hiko?
You're saying she used her sword as a step stool and went out the fucking window? Then what about the sword?
Oh, God.
It would have been left in the shower room and she wouldn't have been able to recover it, dumbass. Well, Hiko, why do you even care?
Yeah, listen. Haji was like, why the fuck do you care for you, Hiko? What the hell's going on here? Dude, this is such a good trial. You cannot tell me that this is not a fucking entertaining.
If she used the bamboo sword as a step stool, it would have been left behind.
Holy shit. Fuyiko, why? Why are you... Even Hajime's like, oh no, now we gotta fight Fuyiko. Oh, fuck off.
Got proof, you bastard. That's obviously impossible.
Right?
Don't fuck with me.
But if we activate our stand ability, it makes it a lot easier. Beaver time, bitch! Yo, I'm killing it. I'm killing it this time. Dude, this song is so good! He's trying to say that the sword would be left behind, but what is he leaving out? There's a big thing he's leaving out. It's not just the sword, that's the thing. He's like, if she would have stepped on the sword, it would have been left behind, dumbass, but there's something very important. And am I losing? He's only got a couple shields left. I gotta go slow again. He's so close to dying. His shields are like, he's got one shield left. There we go. But what about the bamboo sword bag? This is the end. I love the trials because at the end, it's literally... I feel like Nagito a little bit, and that's pretty stupid to say. But, like, it's when, like, hope and despair collide. It all leads up to this final confrontation. If she used the bamboo sword as a step stool, she could have recovered it with the sword bag. Yeah, it has a big string on it. Yeah, look at that! Oh my god, dude! But why go through the effort? Why? Why Mahiru? Why somebody? Why somebody that wasn't even connected to this case? Of all the people, really? Not only was Pecco not even in Twilight Syndrome murder case, she was not related to any of the people fucking in there. She never even met or talked. Did she ever even talk to Mahiru once during the course of this game? Did Pecco and Mahiru ever have any dialogue between them exchanged? Damn, look at that. Yo, Parks, thanks for the boost, dude! Thanks for the boost, man! I'm gonna update that sub counter right now. Thank you so much, dude. That updates, that boosts up two subs for the price of one sub. For some reason, though, we're only at 78, so we must have lost a sub. Anyway, sorry. Usually a boosted sub counts as two subs. Thanks, though, dude. I really appreciate it. I think it was at 76 and then went up to 78. Thanks, man. Wait, Epic Man gifted it? Oh, I'm sorry. Never mind, Parks, you dumb, lazy piece of shit. I'm kidding. Thank you, Epic Man, for gifting it. I read that wrong. Thanks, Epic Man. I'm just messing around. Anyways, here we go. Shh. I was just making a joke. All right. So after she climbed up the window, as long as she hurled the bag towards her, she could get the sword back.
Would have been able to recover her bamboo sword.
That's true, dude. Oh, what the fuck, chat? Sorry, my I did click stuff because my sub. Freak of piss. He wanted it to be Hyoko so bad. He's like, I wanted it to be the Hyoko. I hate that little bitch.
Not just the bamboo sword, but even the sword bag too.
Yeah, why is he so mad? I think he just doesn't like to be proven wrong. I think he's just like, I said it was Hyoko, so I want it to be Hyoko. Because she yelled at me and said I was stupid. Little bitch. She's not really it. She didn't like wall jump up.
Simply put, only Pecco could have performed this feat. An escape plan befitting of the ultimate swordswoman.
True. She is the ultimate swordswoman. So she would use her sword in any possible scenario, even one to escape.
Even so, how disappointing. If you'd only let me work with you, it would have been an even greater plan.
Dude, fuck off, Nagito. Fuck you. He's literally like, ah, man, if only Pecco would have told me, it would have been even better.
You just back off.
He's like, you shut up. This has been a long trial, asshole. This is probably the longest trial yet. Hey, Heathen, thanks so much for the gifted sub, dude. I really appreciate that, man. Thank you. I really do appreciate that. You guys are so kind. Boom, boom. There we go. That was really nice of you, dude. Alright, let's hear. Pecco, did you really kill Mahiru?
Hold on! You're just making assumptions! You don't have any proof. I won't accept this unless there's proof! Got it, you bastard!
It's fine.
Oh no, dude! Pecco's like, it's fine. Oh no, brother, what the fuck?
I said it's fine. Saying anything more would just be an exercise in futility.
She admitted it just now, right? So she admits to killing Mahiru. Oh man, dude. Who would have thought that? She admitted she's Mahiru's killer, right? But is this right? Even though Fuyuhiko was the one arguing with us, Pecco just admitted it.
Among flowers.
That's why this game's so good, Heartbert. Or is it? Are we being tricked again?
I commend your decisiveness.
Why would somebody who has no motive to kill Mahiru be the killer?
Very well.
Let's find out.
If you admit it, this ends now.
What? Brain power is not supposed to be on, dude. I'm gonna have to give you a rain check on that, dude. I'm sorry. That shit should have been turned off a long time ago. My fault, bro. I'll give you a brain power rain check. I cannot play brain power now. This is like the most important part of the trial. I can't. I have to give you a rain check on that. This is like the confrontation with the killer. Okay, just remind me. Next stream, I got you, dude. Anytime you want, you can drop a brain power on. Right, I meant to turn that off. That was my fault. All right, hurry up and vote. Pekko just says, hurry up and vote. She's like, yep, you got it. You got me. Hurry up and vote already. I need to take this off. It's already hot in here again.
Let me confirm one thing first.
Damn it, Chiaki. What do you want to confirm? The killer admitted. The killer admit. Dude, this is just like trial one again. This is already crazy. Again, remember in Danganronpa 1, once you found the killer, it was done. Remember in this game, we did trial one, and then Nagito's like, that's right, I'm the killer. Me, Nagito Komaida. And then it was like, oh, nope, he admitted it, but he wasn't. And then now Pekko's just like, yeah, I'm the killer. And Chiaki's like, well, wait, hold up. What the fuck game is this where even when the killer says that they killed the person, that it's still not over? How the fuck? Can it wait till after the voting? Yeah, thank you, Chiaki. Dude, that's why I love Chiaki. Chiaki's like, what the fuck was the motive? Just to get off the island? What was the motive? This was very weird and intentional and very selective. The killer went out of their way to make sure it was Mahiru at the beach house and Hyoko and this and that. Did Pekko even play the Twilight Syndrome game? Yeah, what was your motive, Pekko? Or else... all of this kind of falls apart and feels a little bit stupid.
In the end,
yeah.
Had no connection to the events depicted in Twilight Syndrome murder case.
Thank you. She had nothing to do with this game. Of all the people that we saw and that were involved, she had nothing to do with it.
Then, why did you kill Mahiru?
Why?
So it's about that. Let's see. If I must answer that question, I must say... it was for the sake of justice.
Justice?
In order to protect the justice of this world.
Oh, shit. What?
I do not sully my hands to satisfy personal grudges. There is only one reason I kill. For the sake of protecting justice.
What are you saying? What are you trying to say, Pekko?
Justice is what makes humans human. It's a virtue that human beings should be proud of. Justice is the eternal sun.
Hey, Georgia, welcome to the stream, dude.
The protective father and the smiling mother. Ever disappeared from this world, the world would immediately freeze and people's smiles would vanish. I will not allow that.
It's fine, just stop it.
It's fine, just stop it.
Justice must always be there to guide us, to shine bright above our heads.
I'm telling you to stop it!
What the fuck is going on, dude? What is happening?
So I must fight. I must continue to fight to protect justice.
Chat, don't say anything.
Could she be?
Look at, oh shit! Oh, this is it! Sonia's like, could she be?
As the light of justice shines upon my mask, I expose the hearts of malevolent evil.
Oh shit, dude! Shining Justice, ooh, the mask.
The center of justice that is pure.
And the music kicks in.
The lead star of justice that shines in the night sky. That would be me. Sparkling justice.
Oh shit! The killer that kills. The criminals, the Batman vigilante, the hidden serial killer on Jabberwock Island, Sparkling Justice, that Sonya read about. I knew that we were right. Remember Chet, when we met her and I was just like, she reminds me a lot of Toko. Boy, oh boy, is this kind of similar to Case 2, isn't it? Remember Case 2, when it was just like, oh, hey, remember these one of the characters? Boom, it's Genocide Jill. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. So, would the... that would provide the motive, Chet, because think about this. Think about this. If Pekko played the game and find out that Mahiru got away with destroying evidence that led to Fuyuhiko's sister's death, maybe Sparkling Justice would be like, this is somebody who got away with covering up a murder. Therefore, I shall enact justice upon the world and erase this criminal. Oh my god. That immediately gives the motive. Thanks, Greg.
Now then, let's execute justice.
She doesn't even care. She's just like, yeah, execute me, bitch. I already fucking did what I wanted. This game is so good. Why is this game so fucking good?
What the fuck?
Yes! I love this! He's like, what the fuck? Oh my god. Epic Man, would you say that you think V3 is better than this? Don't say any spoilers or I'll IP ban you. Holy shit. That reminds me of when in Danganronpa 1, remember when Junko like said all this shit and Yasuhiro was just like, what the hell is wrong with you? I love when the characters react like I react. You could IP ban people, yeah. Twitch added new policies to their stuff. But whatever, that's not important right now. Just please no spoilers. Just don't be a dickhead. We're all here to have fun. Just don't be an asshole, that's all I ask. V3 is decisive. Some people hate it. Some people love it. I don't know. It's some people's least favorite. Some people's favorite. So I don't want to. No more discussion about that. I was just curious.
I am Sparkling Justice.
That's why she had the mask, dude. Again, isn't it funny that when you're like doing the investigation, you see the mask on the ground and you see the water bottles and it's all this really weird little shit that doesn't seem to matter. And then it becomes really. Remember when Sonya's ranting? She's like, oh my god, it had to be Sparkling Justice. And everybody's like, Sonya, shut the fuck up. We're trying to do something. But that was really important.
In the name of Sparkling Shining Justice, I have come to deliver justice.
Look at these fucking emoticons, dude. What is that emotion even? Oh god, Sonya is like, what?
Sparkling Justice is a serial killer who claims to be an ally of justice.
Dude, this is so nuts. Yeah, this is so much better than the Toko reveal. This is so much more impactful than the Toko reveal.
Clad in her various hero masks, she is a serial killer who exclusively targets other criminals. She is supposed to be... ally of justice? So that's why you're wearing a mask. This mask is the dividing line. Just like various idols, the sun is revered because it lies just beyond your hand. Justice should also be the same.
I don't get it, but this is becoming really crazy.
This music, too, is so crazy, right? What the heck is this? Pekko's the killer? Why is it turning out like this?
This is turning out to be a surprising turn of events.
I love it. Dude, even Monomi's like, yeah, this is getting pretty weird. Monokuma's like, I'm bored, dude. How long have we been here? It's like a 17-hour trial. Hurry up, dumbasses. Hurry up and vote.
Now's not the time for you to be sleeping. Take a look. It's a killer.
It's the killer.
Hey.
You know. This bullshit, hurry up. Oh god, I didn't even realize that. That was like a fourth wall thing. Monokuma was like, this again? I didn't even realize that. I think that that's no more than just a reference, like a fourth wall break reference, to the player being like, hey, do you guys remember? Maybe I'm reaching, but Monokuma saying in his sleep, this again? I feel like that was a reference to how in Case 2 of Danganronpa 1, there was also a serial killer revealed.
So what's your answer to my previous
Maybe I'm just...
question. Why did you kill Mahiru? This world must always be bathed in the light of justice. I must not allow evil.
Mahiru wasn't evil. Hey, getting rid of evidence from a murder and actually committing a murder, I don't care what anybody says. Even if both are bad, one of them's way worse. Killing somebody is way worse than, like, burning a picture of somebody of evidence.
If you knew about that incident, then you must have played the game.
So, we had never even considered the fact that Pekko would have played the game, because why the hell would we care? There was no evidence connecting Pekko to these incidents.
And because of that, I was able to find the killer's accomplice hiding on this island like a sewer rat.
Then, the reason you killed Mahiru was...
So, she was like, I was finally able to find the killer's accomplice on this island. What are the chances of that shit? Oh, God. No, the winner's gift was an envelope filled with photographs showing that girl A, B, C, and D were based on Ibuki, Mahiru, Hyoko, and Mikan. That was the winner. That was the winner's gift.
In order to protect justice, I have become its merciless sword and executed justice.
Ibuki! All of these trials are like hell on earth. It's literal chaos. No wonder Nagito has like a hard on watching this shit. Could you imagine being in this moment, seeing this absolute like psychotic event take place? Hajime is just like, I don't even know what my ultimate is.
Pekko, is this your true identity?
Exactly, Epic Man. That's why no matter what, I have to finish this LP. I have to finish this LP because Case 5 and 6, like, I have to. I have to get to the end. We gotta make it.
My true identity? I have already forgotten who I am.
What?
It just shows my determination. My determination to protect by throwing away what's most important.
This is legit your favorite video game ever? I love Danganronpa, dude. I love Danganronpa. Right.
I'm willing to become anybody to shower this world with justice.
We'll all miss Mahiru, but right now, it's time for revenge. Sparkling justice must fall this moment. Holy shit, dude. Yeah, remember Case 2 of Danganronpa 1? Where they're like, wait a second, it was Mondo! And he's like, yeah, it is me. I fucked up. In this one, there's like a serial killer. He's like, I just did justice. I just fucking... She's like, Mahiru deserved it. She was evil. I just eliminated the evil from the world.
I can't stand this anymore. Let's just end this farce already.
Let's do it. Mondo was sad, but like, this is way better of a climax to the case, I think. End it. He's right. Let's do it. Let's end this shit. And punishment time. In the end, there's no mistake that it was Pekko all along.
Let's go over this incident one more time and then let's end this.
Alright. It's the part that I'm really bad at, chat. I, for some reason, suck so bad at the closing arguments on this game, but I'll try my best. Here we go, wish me luck. All right, we gotta take it from the top. How did this murder take place? Let's find out. Look at how sad my poor little Mahiru-chan is. It is okay, Mahiru-chan. Now you can take pictures in heaven. On the morning of the incident, Mahiru met with... What the fuck, dude? They're gagging fucking poor Hyoko. Okay, that's it. Okay. In order to lure in Mahiru and Hyoko, they had to what, switch? They had to forge two letters. Or no, is this before? No, this is it. They forged two letters, mailed them. Okay, so I gotta focus. This part, I always suck at for some reason. I think it's because it's all jumbled up. My brain works in terms of, like, chronological order. And this, you're not able to do it chronological order because you have to, like, do it in parts. So it's harder for me, for my brain to wrap my head around this. The first one to arrive at the beach house was... Hyoko-chan! Then she was chloroformed, put in the closet... They're stared over her body. They put the yellow gummy on the floor. The next one that arrived at the beach house was... Sweet. Look how poor... No! Look at my poor girl. She has no idea. Look at this demon behind her. This... No! She had no idea. That's fucked up. Dude, fuck Pecco. Pecco bitch. What did the killer leave next to the body? The sparkling justice mask. Mahiru was sweet. She was the only one nice to Hyoko and taught her how to tie her sash. Now then, time to wash off the blood. That's not on here. Where should I hide? That was also not. Oh my god. Look at how scared poor Hyoko is. The first one that found the body was Hyoko. That's also not on there. There's Hyoko eating a gummy. She's eating the red gummy. She doesn't eat yellow gummies. Hyoko left a big piece of evidence. Dude, I don't friggin' know. In the closet after Hyoko ran away. To retrieve the bamboo sword, they had to tie it. Okay. Look how cute Chiaki is there. Look at, there's just cute Chiaki. Just sitting there with the ice cream she brought. Hey, wouldn't you look scared if you just discovered a dead body? Yeah, I don't friggin' know. What am I missing here? Oh, God. Okay. I got this. No pressure. Time to wash off the blood that was not on there. Where should I hide? The surfboard's not there. Hyoko left a big piece of... Is this just a gummy? No, that's not... Oh, footprints. That's not right either. I am so freaking lost, dude. When did the killer have the bat? There is no, like, time for this. Dude, when was Hyoko passed out? Hyoko was still sleeping? I think I'm gonna get this wrong, but... Dude, I knew it was wrong. Was she still sleeping here? What the fuck? I am so confused. Hyoko made a promise with someone? Okay, maybe this is where it was supposed to go. Nah, I couldn't tell. I thought she was eating a fucking gummy. Alright, whatever. Now everything should be pretty easy. Yeah, because she left the footprints. Okay, I don't know how that picture of her eating the gummy mentioned that she had a promise she had upheld. But that's fine. We got everything's good now. She left the footprints in the sand. It was a big no-no. First one to discover the body was Hyoko. She woke up. What the hell does Mikan have to do with this shit? Kind of covered in blood. The killer dropped the fruit gummy. Was that this one or the other one? Did I wash off the blood? Or should I hide? No, okay, never mind. Dude, I'm getting fucked up. She eats the gummy. In the closet after Hyoko ran away, they placed the yellow gummy. Okay. And then final things here. Okay. We're figuring this out. Where should I hide? In the surfboard case. Time to wash off the blood with the water bottles. Good, good, good. Here's everything that happens.
The incident began this morning when Mahiru spoke to Hyoko.
Alright. We're gonna go through this case from top to bottom, vote and kill the killer, but I gotta get a bottle of water. Funny enough, very topical, I have to get a bottle of water because I'm thirsty as shit. It's right outside my door, so don't go anywhere. Alright? Keep yourselves entertained. I'm back. Sorry, I had to clean myself off with water to wash off Mahiru's blood. Alright, we're good. So this is the case from top to bottom.
Mahiru most likely played Twilight Syndrome murder case, the video game provided to us as the motive. She probably wanted to discuss it with someone else who also appeared in the game as a character.
Hyoko. Okay. Top to bottom, here we go. And they promised to. For anybody that didn't watch this full trial, here is the summary. So I won't talk over.
However, someone else overheard their exchange. The killer. The killer eavesdropped on their conversation and used their promise to devise a specific murder plan. By preparing a specific item, they plan to manipulate the two's actions. That item was the letters. They sent fake letters to both Mahiru and Hyoko.
I know a lot of people hate Mahiru. I know a lot of people hate her, but I kind of like her a little bit. Especially after this. She almost got blamed and she loved Mahiru. Probably more than me.
And the letter Hyoko received told her to come to the beach house at exactly 2 p.m.
That's why when Depri started playing this game, and he was just like, he's like, oh, my favorite character is Mahiru. I was just like, ow, ow, ow.
By providing different times, the killer was able to lure them to the beach house separately. Hyoko totally trusted that letter, showed up at the beach house at 2 p.m., just like it said, and was drugged into unconsciousness by the killer lying in wait. After putting Hyoko to sleep, the killer immediately hid her inside the closet, so they could frame her as the killer later.
Damn, dude. They literally picked up this girl, set her down, said, we're gonna frame you for being the killer. Alright. Aware that she'd been targeted for murder.
Approaching her from behind, the killer struck the defenseless Mahiru with a specific weapon, the metal bat that was left at the scene of the crime. The bat was brought down onto the back of Mahiru's head, and with that, she took her last breath.
That's so sad, dude.
According to Mikan's autopsy, Mahiru died instantly, so she probably never knew who killed her.
Wow. That's even more sad. Well, I guess that's less sad. Mahiru died, and like she never even knew who's the one that killed her. She got hit in the back of the head.
With that, the killer achieved their goal of killing Mahiru and began to tamper with the crime scene. They dragged Mahiru's body so that it blocked the door leading to the road. Also, the mask found at the scene of the crime was something the killer personally left.
Damn, they took the mask off and just set it next to the body.
I'm not really sure why. My guess is it's something similar to a calling card. That's how the crime scene we discovered was created. However, by moving Mahiru's body, the killer got blood splatter on them. Plus, the shower room had no water because it was out of order, so they couldn't wash it off. But the killer expected something like that to happen. Instead of the shower, the killer used something else to wash the blood off their body. They used plastic water bottles.
Look at how, like, crazy complicated this case was.
We can assume they carried the bottles to the shower room before the sequence of events had happened. In place of showering, they washed the blood off their body with water bottles instead. However, they had no choice but to dispose of the empty bottles in the beach house's trash can. Littering is against the rules, and it would have taken too much time to throw them away somewhere else.
It's true.
After the killer washed off the blood, they hid in a specific spot inside the closet Hyoko was in. The killer hid inside the surfboard case that they had already emptied beforehand. After some time had passed, the sleeping drug used on Hyoko wore off, and she woke up. I can imagine how badly Hyoko must have panicked when she came out of the closet.
Yeah, right? Poor Hyoko. She just, like, went to the beach house. She's like, I'm gonna meet up with Mahiru today. And gets knocked out, wakes up in the closet, opens the door, just sees, like, her fucking best friend smashed her head in.
I mean, she made plans to see Mahiru, who lay dead right in front of her. From the shock and panic of being considered a murder suspect, Hyoko fled from the beach house. Because of that, she left footprints in the sand. Everything was a trap set by the killer to frame her.
Damn.
After Hyoko left, the killer finally came out of the surfboard case and placed a gummy that they
the gummy
to shift our suspicion toward Hyoko. Ironically, placing that gummy is what helped clear our
Yeah, that was actually funny. So the killer placed that to try to frame Hyoko, but that ended up being like a definitive piece of information to like show her innocence.
Finally, the killer began preparing to escape from the beach house. They couldn't risk leaving their footprints in the sand, so they escaped the beach house using a different route. The small window in the shower room.
So, yeah, when Pekko met up with everybody and we were all talking about, they were like, damn, Pekko was looking cute. She was only looking cute because she just got done killing Mahiru, was fucking heading.
That window was
yeah, she hates the yellow gummies. She only buys the other gummies that don't have the lemon flavor.
The bamboo sword they always carry with them. The killer took the bamboo sword out of its bag, tied the bag to the sword's handle, and used the sword as a step stool to reach the small window while holding the sword bag in their hand.
Damn.
As long as they're able to reach the window, all they had to do was pull the bag to retrieve the sword.
And then she met up with everybody else.
And appeared before us as if nothing had happened. But their wet hair and swimsuit didn't dry right away. There also weren't any towels at the beach house.
So she just had to say, hey, I went for a swim.
So when the killer met up with us, they said they had been swimming for a while as an excuse. So how about it? This is the truth behind the incident you caused.
Isn't that right?
Pekko Pekko Yama.
Pekko Pekko Yama? What do you mean, Harper? Dang, dude. Complete.
I see.
I see.
And what of it? She's like totally cool with it. I haven't done anything to be ashamed of.
She's like, I didn't do anything to be ashamed of. Mahiru was evil. It was right of me. Yeah, Mahiru was good. She was sweet. She was a sweetheart.
I punished evil in the name of justice.
Damn.
That's no reason to condemn you. Whatever. Let's hurry up and vote so we can freaking kill this weird, crazy bitch.
Damn, Hyoko. All right.
There's no way you can kill me.
Uh-oh. There's no way you can kill me. What if she just, like, took out her sword and just started killing everybody? And Monokuma was like, whoa.
Justice can never be killed. You should all know that as well.
She's like, even if you strike me down, justice will continue.
What are you saying?
To protect what's most important to you, you must be prepared to throw away something equally important.
So she was willing to throw away her life to uphold justice. Yeah, Mahiru wasn't that bad. Jeez Louise.
I don't get it. I don't get it at all. Then I shall be direct. Justice must carry on. In order to keep justice, to keep me alive, you all must give up your lives.
Whoa. So she's saying you guys need to vote wrong on purpose so that you all die and you let me live. She's like, I'm justice. If you want to do what's right, you have to kill yourselves so that I may live. Holy shit.
Are you serious?
This is so... Yeah, this is the most insane one yet.
It's not serious. It's justice. If I fall here, who will combat the evils of this world?
It's like, if I die, who's going to fight off the evil of the world? It's up to you guys to sacrifice yourself for me. Holy shit, she's like, save my life to protect justice. Fuck off.
And carry on justice.
Holy shit.
Give me a break. Who's gonna die for you?
Yeah, right, we need to vote already.
If we let Pekko go, we're all gonna get killed. For the sake of grand justice, a few sacrifices are unavoidable.
That's a lot of sacrifices, dude. I would never in my life. I would maybe consider, like, sacrificing myself if it was to, like, stop Monokuma. You know what I mean? But, like, just... It would, what, stop Mahiru? A girl with a camera? Right, thank you, Hyoko. Let's do this. What did Sonya want to say? They cut her off. Sonya's like, hey, before that, and then Nakamura's like, shut up, bitch! Alright, let's vote!
Who will be chosen as the blackened? Will you make the right choice or the dreadfully wrong one?
Let's find out!
Such heart-pounding excitement!
Alright, and we cast our votes. And the blackened is... Peko Peko Yama, guilty of the murder of Mahiru Koizumi.
Pardon me, can we please have a little more time?
What? Oh shit! It's not over yet, Snake. It's not over yet. Sonya's like, hey, wait. This trial? It ain't done yet, bro. What? Sonya says, no, stop it. It's not over, is it ever gonna... This is so wild. Oh no.
Continue our discussion? But isn't the voting over?
Yes, but I cannot help but feel strange. Something about this is definitely strange.
Huh?
Strange? What do you mean? There's no doubt that Peko is the killer.
That is...
Somebody in chat brought up a good point. There is something that still has not been addressed. There's something that has not been addressed yet.
As a serial killer enthusiast, you're wondering if Peko is really sparkling justice, am I right?
Wait.
Hey, Miss Sonya isn't a serial killer enthusiast. She just has a little more passion about them than most.
So Sonya is like, well, wait just a moment. I'm not fully convinced that Peko is really sparkling justice. What? Did Peko lie about being sparkling justice?
That makes her an enthusiast.
Honestly, it felt strange to me too. I mean, there's a distinct difference between what we know about sparkling justice and Peko, right?
Chet, do you remember the investigation? What did Sonya tell us about sparkling justice? Remember? Were you guys paying attention? There was when Sonya... Remember Sonya was talking about Genocide Jack and Sparkling Justice? And I thought it was weird. And... It's, apparently Sonya thought it was a little weird too.
You know, Sonya described Sparkling Justice like this.
Alright, let's listen back. Nagito remembers. I don't know how the hell fucking he knows.
Justice complete.
Oh, here we go. That's what she said. Okay, what's weird about that? And then Hajime was like, what was that? That's Sparkling Justice's catchphrase. An unknown serial killer has a catchphrase? I read it in a magazine in the library. There has only ever been one person, a journalist, that has interviewed Sparkling Justice. The article was written in their native language, so I tried translating it. That's what it was. Damn. So, remember Sonya said, Sparkling Justice, what she said? Sonya had to translate. Sonya translated that herself, which means let's just, I know they speak Japanese, but for the sake of this game, English. Just for the sake of this. That means English isn't Sparkling Justice's native language. So how would it have been Pekko? The nationality would be very different. Pekko's Japanese, but Sonya knows that Sparkling Justice isn't Japanese.
The article was written in their native language, so I tried to translate it.
If she had a translator, that means it wasn't written in English, right?
right, Harper? So, yeah. So, how the fuck would Pekko actually be Sparkling Justice if she said all that whole catchphrase? And that wasn't even in her native language.
Yes, the magazine I read was
written in Spanish, which means Sparkling Justice is of Hispanic descent, not Japanese. So, again, this game is so good because we were all tricked into thinking, oh shit, this is just like Case 2. But like Monokuma said, this again? No. The creators of Danganronpa 2 said, we can't just do the same thing again. We can't have another serial killer show up and that's the answer? Fooled you again, dumbasses! Pekko lied! There is no Sparkling Justice on this island. It was another part of the killer's ploy.
So, Sparkling Justice's catchphrase was no doubt written in Spanish as well.
Oh, shit. Sonya, I guarantee, Sonya's going to say, okay, Pekko, if you really are Sparkling Justice, say that exact same catchphrase in Spanish. And if you can't, then there's no way that you're the real Sparkling Justice.
Which means the journalist and Sparkling Justice are both
from Spain?
What?
All this time, I completely misunderstood. When I first heard about the serial killers, Genocide Jack and Sparkling Justice, I assume both killers were from the same country. You assume that they're both from the same country and you forget about the details. But that wasn't the case. If so,
Pekko, you're not Sparkling Justice. There's no way that's possible.
She's not.
Or you insist that you're Sparkling
Justice. Chiaki's the one that did it. Chiaki says, okay, well, if you are Sparkling Justice, just say the catchphrase in Spanish. Would you be able to do that, Pekko Pekko Yama? That's the least Spanish name I ever heard.
It appears that the time has come for this mask to come off. However, that's perfectly fine. It's no longer necessary.
Oh god, more plot twist.
And even if you find out now, it's too late for you all to do anything about it.
This is like some Skull Kid shit. She's like, even if you find out the truth, it's too late. What the fuck, Pekko?
My duty has already been finished.
Whoa.
My duty as a tool has already been completed in full.
Whoa. She's like, doesn't matter if I'm not Sparkling Justice. It's too late. I've already completed my task.
Uh-huh. Looks like she's back to normal.
That mask has fulfilled its purpose, just as I have.
What do you mean? Fulfilled its purpose too late? What are you getting at?
Now that you've already cast your vote, is what it means.
Uh-oh. What does that mean? Now that we've already voted, it's too late? What's that mean? Huh? This is the best case yet.
I'm asking you what your purpose was.
Was Pekko's job to make them vote the wrong killer?
I have no purpose. I am just a mere tool. What do you mean?
She called herself a tool. Which means someone else used her then?
Look at her face, dude.
I see. I finally understand. Well, I did have a sneak
That's what Chad was talking about. They never addressed the body discovery announcement. There was somebody else there that discovered the body. That's what we never talked about. And Nagito knew that all along. He knew the whole time.
Someone else?
No, Taters. What that lottery thing means is that that's who they voted for. Whatever shows up is who they voted for. Then Monokuma has to be like, you got it right or you got it wrong. That's just to show what the majority vote was. Taters was talking about when they vote and it does like the slot machine thing. It's like ding, 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 ding. Yeah, that just shows who the majority vote was.
There is proof that establishes that fact. Try to remember it.
He didn't say shit yet. The proof that there was another person at the crime scene was the body discovery announcement proves it. You guys were on that shit from the beginning. Chat, you was talking about that from the beginning.
Yep, that's right. I mean, didn't Monokuma say so earlier?
They said three. He said not including the killer. Look at him. You want me to say it? It doesn't include the killer this time, okay? All done.
That announcement is made when at least three people discover a body.
True.
And in this particular case, the killer, Pekko, is not one of those three. If that's the case, it would mean only Hyoko and Kazuichi discovered the body, but...
I see. That leaves us one person short.
So that means there was one more person in the beach house.
There was somebody else, dude. Holy shit. Yeah.
It's such a vital clue that it could alter the outcome of the trial. Like an accomplice, for example.
Yeah, the fact that Monokuma tried to hide that detail meant that it was important.
No.
And Nagito picked up on that.
It.
Oh, Pekko said nope. Uh-oh.
Huh? Am I wrong?
Oh, shit.
Yes. From your basic way of thinking about it, you are wrong. Didn't I tell you? I'm just a tool. That means I'm just a simple tool.
That person would have the strongest motive out of anybody else here, right?
Who would have the strongest motive to kill Mahiru Koizumi?
You're the only one! Is it for you, Nico?
Oh, shit, bro.
I see. Now I finally see the connection.
He's been freaking out the whole time.
But even if it's the motive, it's just a game, right? There's no reason to believe it's even true.
Akane, did you not pay any fucking attention? We proved... Oh, man, this bitch, I swear, gives me a brain aneurysm.
Would you call a game like that strong motive?
Yes, I would. It was based on real shit. How do we know that the game is real? What's the proof? Where is it? Yes, the ending prize showed off all the proof that we needed that the game was based on real events. Whoops. It had the pictures of all the characters, the pictures of the victim, their identities.
Confirm it if it didn't have anything to do with Mahiru's murder, but there's no doubt that game is based on actual events. That much is clear if you saw the ending prize.
The ending prize is literally pictures of the people involved and the pictures of Fuyuhiko's dead little sister. Yeah, there's them.
Photos awarded for beating the game are not actual.
Can we just talk about how fucking great Ibuki's socks are? You see those thigh highs? They're like the black thigh highs with like the skull bones on them? Perfect. There, that's all I had to get that out of my system.
Actual photos with the surrounding scenery cropped out.
Isn't it funny, though, that even if those characters had their memories erased, think about that. Even if those characters had their memories erased, their personality dynamics were the same. And that's kind of cool. That even if they didn't remember each other, that, like, Hyoko still treated Mikan the same way. Like, they all knew each other. Ibuki acted the same way. Mahiru was still kind of close to Hyoko. It's super weird that even with their memories erased, they still kind of fell into those same interpersonal relationships. And he knew the whole time who the killer was. We gotta keep playing till the execution. I will not stop playing till execution. Oh shit, that's right. Remember when we played? This was like hours ago. Fucking days ago. Remember we bumped into Fuyuhiko? He's like, what the fuck are you doing here? And he had an envelope in his hand? That was the prize. He had that in his arm the whole time.
It was the envelope, right? The person who received the ending prize. It was you, wasn't it? If you were shown a photograph of your sister's dead body, you'd have no choice but to believe it.
Yeah, that's true.
Even so, you wanted to deny the truth. That's why you sent those photos to Mahiru to confirm it.
Hey, why are we talking about Fuyuhiko? Who cares? Because Peko is the killer, right? But we already voted.
Yeah, they already voted. They already voted. They're, Monokuma said there's no take-backs.
That's why I told you. You're all too late. As I said before, I exist as nothing more than two. I had no motive for killing Mahiru.
Wow.
No
yeah.
Reason to kill. Not even the will to kill. I was simply used as a tool. As long as I am a tool, I cannot.
Oh god, look at him.
Hey, what's going on? Can anyone give me a simpler explanation? I'm the true killer who used me as their weapon to kill Mahiru Koizumi was Fuyuhiko Kuzuriyu.
So she's saying that the actual killer was Fuyuhiko. And she wanted to get everybody to vote for her in order to save him. But why?
What?
Gundam's like, oh shit, we fucked up.
What the hell?
Dude, they got tricked, bro. They all got tricked.
I see. That's what you were aiming for all along.
No, I have no aim. But my young master does.
My young master?
My young master planned this from the start.
Young master?
Uh-oh.
Is the truth of this case.
That's the truth of this case.
I'm sure you realize it by now, but it's too late.
You can't undo the vote.
I cannot undo the vote.
She wanted to trick them. She pretended to be Sparkling Justice, put the clues here, all this, so that they would vote for her.
That's a problem.
Damn, even Chiaki, look at Chiaki's like, uh-oh, this is an issue.
Peko's allegation holds up. That means our vote was incorrect.
Oh god, they fucking voted wrong. Fuyuhiko. He's the one. He's the one that gets away with it. So there's the argument. How do you think Monokuma is gonna handle this? Peko is saying that I'm just a tool. I only did what Fuyuhiko wanted. I was his weapon, and he was the mastermind, so he's the actual killer. But they're like, no, that's bullshit. You're a human being. You're not the same thing as a fucking bat or as a wrench or an inanimate object. You're the killer. So now we have to try to convince Monokuma whether Fuyuhiko's the mastermind or if Peko is a legitimate person enough to the point where she would be the real killer, even though she doesn't think she is.
That's not for you to decide. It's for Monokuma.
Yeah, that's what Peko says. It's not for us to decide. It's up to Monokuma's decision.
The votes have been cast. All we can do now is wait and see what Monokuma decides.
Oh, God.
What the hell?
Dude, Hajime's like, what the hell? the hell is my ultimate? I sucked balls at this trial. Well, no, maybe. I got a lot of good points. I guess I did a lot better than I thought. That was a long-ass trial, bro. 14 parts. Shit. Alright, Monokuma. Alright, Monokuma, what do you have to say about this, buddy? Another break, dude? No, we want to... No, no, dickhead. Another commercial? Alright, even though there's some twists and turns along the way, the one that killed my hero Koizumi is... Oh, hold on a sec. Okay, I'll wait. I'm just hesitating. No matter how you look at it, chat, what do you think? You guys are going to be a little bit biased because you probably want the your characters you like to live. But what do you guys think? Is Fuyuhiko the killer or is Pekko the killer? Who is the mastermind? Before you guys answer, keep this in mind. In Danganronpa 1, Hifumi did kill Taka, but Celeste was the mastermind. Which is why she also was charged with it. Then again, Celeste also did literally beat Hifumi's brains out. So, whatever. That's a little bit different, but still. If Fuyuhiko ordered it, then he is the killer. I agree with you, Harper. Hey. You're not a tool, you're a freaking human being. If I'm a human, then I'm not a tool. Is that what you're saying? If that's what you're saying, you're wrong. You just don't know that there are people who only exist to be tools. Alright, buckle up. People such as myself. We don't even understand why she's like this. Only exist to be tools? What does she mean, Fuyuhiko? Yeah, Fuyuhiko, you tell us, mastermind. Oh, shit. Pekko and I grew up together. So they knew each other. They knew... This whole time, you have no idea that they knew each other. But they knew each other. So, and the reason why they remember is they only had their school memories erased. They only had their school memories erased. But if him and Pekko actually grew up together from when they were children, they would still remember that. And they would still remember each other. So that means from the moment we entered this island, Fuyuhiko and Pekko were childhood friends. But they never made that clear to anybody. Yeah, childhood friends. No. It's completely different than that. Right after I was born and abandoned by my parents, the Kuzuryu clan took me in. Man, even more lore. All this lore. Let's keep going. They gave me a reason to exist. I am to fulfill my duty as my young master's property. So, Pekko was an orphan as a kid. She was abandoned by her parents. And the Kuzuryu clan took her in on the agreement that she would be pretty much a bodyguard or a tool to Fuyuhiko.
What?
It means she's a hitman arranged by my clan to work directly under me. Damn, dude, look at this dude.
I must defend him as his shield. If he intends to kill, I must be his sword.
Damn, look at him. Look at from the time they were babies. Let me remove my face cam so you guys can see this. Damn, look at this. From the time they were babies, she still had a sword. Then they grew up when they were kids. They went to school together. They were colluding this whole time. And we had no idea.
That is my only reason for living.
Dang.
Before I am human, I am my young master's tool, first and foremost.
So she exists to do exactly what he says, no matter what. So if he orders, he's like, hey, Pekko, get rid of Mahiru. Then she will just do it. She may have no personal stake in it, but she has sworn her entire life to carry out any act that he wanted.
Until this body of mine can no longer move, I shall fulfill my duty until the very end. That is...
You're not a tool, Pekko. Because if you're a tool, then what was all that time we spent together?
Nothing.
Damn. They're like, what about all the memories we had? What about the weeks we spent on this island getting to know each other and hanging out? Just meant shit. Meant nothing. She's just like, Fuyuhiko ordered me to behave and just act and interact with you guys. Dang, Hajime's like, whoa. Our professional relationship doesn't exist on this island. We're just fellow high school students now. Right after we arrived on this island, that is what Fuyuhiko told her to do. So the moment they arrived on the island, Fuyuhiko said, don't act like we know each other and still follow under my orders.
You fiend.
Damn, so they hid their relationship from the beginning.
No.
My young master has always told me to hide our relationship. He loathes relying on his household's power. He even hates me, the tool given to him by his household. Damn, dude.
I am nothing but a tool.
No matter what I'm told, I'm nothing but a tool for killing. If my young master intends to kill, it is only natural for me to act as his tool. Then the one that tried to kill Mahiru wasn't you. It was Fuyuhiko. So they voted wrong, Chet. They voted wrong, dude! That means Fuyuhiko was the true killer. If Fuyuhiko said, hey, kill Mahiru, and she did, that makes Fuyuhiko the real mastermind, which is what we're supposed to figure out.
Damn it.
It is what it is. When I thought I beat the game, I was suddenly given those photographs.
Damn it.
Why is my sister in these photos?
Don't fuck with me!
She's covered in blood. What does it mean? Why can't I remember? How come I don't even know if my sister's dead?
You
tried to confirm it with Mahiru, and that's why you wanted to talk to her.
So?
I sent her the photo because I wanted to make sure she would respond. But she never replied back to me. Not only that, she started avoiding me too. So Chet, remember? Remember how they kept having like breakfast meetings and going to the pool? And they were like, how come Mahiru's not coming? She was trying to avoid Fuyuhiko. That's why she was always on the beach by herself, and she didn't want to talk, she didn't want to hang out, she didn't want to do anything, because she didn't want to be around Fuyuhiko.
But
I'm pretty sure Mayuru was confused too. I mean, we all were. Yeah, they all have their memories deleted. Nobody can remember shit. Before anyone played the game, we didn't even know this incident had happened. That's why even if we're told that we're connected to it, there's no way we could accept it. You know, when Mahiru spoke to Ibuki, she mentioned something about this. I have plans to go to the beach with everyone.
Oh my.
You're not gonna go, Mahiru? If you want to talk about it there, it'd be totally fine. Mahiru says, it's pretty important, so, you know, it'd be troubling to involve the others.
Huh?
You sound pretty serious.
Serious
or not, I can't really do anything about it on my own, so I wanted someone to think about it with me.
But
if I need to make amends, I would, but I don't even know how.
Are you serious?
That definitely sounds serious. I can cancel my beach plans for you. That's fine. It's important that everyone gets along anyway. Just tell them I'm not feeling well. It doesn't have to be today. There's always tomorrow. That's fucked up. One of her last words was, there's always tomorrow. But that was the last day that she was alive. It's like, there's always tomorrow. So we just found out that Mahiru found out the truth, and she actually felt bad. She just wanted to talk about it with Hyoko. And she even said, she's like, if there's any way to make amends, I would. I need to figure out more stuff. Mahiru felt bad. Look at her. She's like, if I really did this, I feel like shit. She just wanted to talk to Hyoko about it.
Oh.
She wanted to discuss how to make amends, but Hyoko was the only one that accepted her invitation. Wow, that's even more fucked up. Mahiru wanted to talk to everybody, so she invited Mikan, Ibuki, Hyoko, but Hyoko was the only one that showed up. Everybody else was like, oh, I already have plans to swim. She wanted to talk to everybody about it. Damn, Ibuki's like, I should have gone too.
But
it was rather convenient for you, wasn't it, Fuyuhiko? If you could make use of their plan to meet each other alone, you could easily lure Mahiru into a trap, right?
Hey.
By calling both of them to the beach house, you were able to pin the blame on Hyoko.
What the?
Damn. An eye for an eye. That's the world that I live in. My little sister was murdered. If the reason that happened was because of some person here, I have no choice but to kill that person on my sister's behalf, right? Hey, Shen. And so my young master thought of a plan and executed it. I wanted to use a bat as the murder weapon, because in the game, that what was used to kill Girl E. For revenge, clubbing the person to death the same way my sister was killed just seemed to make sense. Even if it ruined my disguise, it was the only thing I could do to avenge my sister.
That is...
So that's why you killed Mahiru with the bat? He said, but still, I believed her up until the last minute that that game was just a work of fiction. So what actually happened? But even still, that bitch... What happened? This is what happened in the beach house. This is what went down. Mahiru was in the beach house and she said, hey, if that game is actually real, are you the one that killed Girl E? So Mahiru and Fuyuhiko actually talked in the beach house. That gives me goosebumps, dude. That means they actually got to meet and discuss this. And remember, Girl E was Mahiru's friend. So Mahiru isn't evil. Fuyuhiko literally beat Mahiru's friend to death with a bat. He's like, are you the one that killed Girl E?
Why you?
Hey, I don't want to hear about that.
But...
The fact that your sister was killed is terrible. It's unfortunate, but...
Why?
You shouldn't have killed that girl.
Shut the hell up!
Who cares about that? Just answer me. What do you know about that game?
What do you say?
You had no right to do that. Nobody has the right to judge others for their crimes. Revenge is just wrong.
Jeez.
You want me to be honest? This whole time, I was acting like a coward. Even after I called over Mahiru, I was still trying to find an excuse to not go through with the plan. But after she said that to me, that all went out the window. I got really pissed off and grabbed the metal bat that I hid under the bench. But at that moment, Young Master called for me and made me kill Mahiru.
Huh?
Huh? Damn.
I am finished.
Look at Fuyuhiko's like, haha, fuck yeah, Pekko, get her. That's fucked up. Once you actually see what went down, it's even more fun. And think about this. While this is going on, this was happening at the same time we're all looking at, like, Chiaki's big titties and shit. We're all sitting in there, we're like, damn, Chiaki looking good. Oh, Chiaki brought us ice cream. Oh, what a great girl. Oh, Akane got blood on her head. Like, all this shit. We're thinking about all this while this is happening.
What?
Are you saying that you killed because you were ordered to? A tool is not defined by its will, but by its actions. I don't get this girl at all.
Of course
you don't understand, because humans are completely different from one another. Everyone's birthplace and upbringing are different. It's obviously impossible for them to understand each other. So everyone just pretends to understand and pretends to be understood.
Be quiet.
Hey, you're too annoying. Can you be quiet?
Yes, indeed.
Okie dokie, I'll be quiet. Damn, Chucky, you fucking shut him up quick. Looks like being polite works against Monokuma. Like, hey, Mr. Monokuma, can you please shut up? He's like, all right. Afterward, just as my young master planned, I proceeded to tamper with the scene of the crime. However, I also considered the possibility of being found out. So in order to get you guys to make the wrong choice, I decided to make use of the serial killer story. So she was just like, I want to make sure I protect Fuyuhiko no matter what. So I'm going to dress up like a serial killer and pretend that I'm sparkling justice. Then you guys will all vote for me and then I can be like, haha, I tricked you. Now my master is safe and you guys all die. That was her plan. And... he's just like, we fell for a trick all along. That's right, you guys made the wrong decision. You voted for me, a mere tool, as the killer, unaware that my young master was the true killer.
That's obviously wrong.
No.
It should be decided already. Isn't that right, Monokuma?
This is troubling.
I'll admit, all this talk about Pekko being a tool sounds pretty persuasive. When you approach it from various angles, it makes sense that Fuyuhiko's the true killer. Oh no, we're fucked. He's like, yeah, it makes sense. Fuyuhiko would be the true killer.
I see.
So for Pekko, Fuyuhiko himself is your true hope then. On his behalf, you killed Mahiru, and now you're trying to sacrifice us so you can protect him.
Great.
You would only go that far because he's your one and only hope.
Wrong.
I have no hope. I'm just a tool. Well, even if we ask her, she's probably just gonna play dumb anyway.
Now then.
So I'm gonna ask someone else. Hey, Fuyuhiko, what do you think?
Huh?
About what?
Hey.
Is Pekko just a tool to you? Using that tool, surviving by sacrificing Pekko and the rest of us. Is that your hope?
What?
Oh, shit. You tell us, Fuyuhiko. Tell us.
Hold on.
What's the use of asking something like that?
What?
You seem distressed. A mere tool doesn't panic like that, right?
Jeez.
Pekko, be honest. Are you trying to protect Fuyuhiko of your own free will? Oh, shit. So, again, Nagito's a piece of shit, but he's actually... I gotta put on my shirt because I'm getting chilly. He's actually so fucking smart, dude. I don't care what anybody says. Nagito's kind of fucking insane. What's up, Icy? So, he's trying to say things to provoke Pekko because... He's trying to say things to provoke Pekko because he's just like, I don't know. You seem pretty emotional. I don't know if emotions are something that a tool has. So, if Nagito can trick Pekko into showing emotion, then that proves that she's not just a tool, and that proves that they were all right in picking her as the real killer. Oh my god, dude. What the fuck? The fact that she killed on your behalf, the fact that she lied to us by acting like the killer, are those all of the things that you ordered her to do? Is that the truth? That's exactly what Harper said. Harper literally said, he's like, well, if Fuyuhiko ordered her to kill Mahiru, then Fuyuhiko is the mastermind. Absolutely. I would actually agree with that. If Fuyuhiko sat there and said, Pekko, kill Mahiru, then he would be the mastermind. So let's ask Fuyuhiko, did you order her to do these things? Fuyuhiko?
Yeah.
I know you hate our guts, but...
Huh?
If you listen to Pekko, we're all gonna die.
Young master.
You just have to tell them the truth. I was only following your orders. You just have to tell them that. Pekko's just like, just tell them. Tell them I was just following your orders. Hajime says, Fuyuhiko? You mentioned this before, but... In this kind of situation, interacting with others will just shorten your lifespan. Those idiots, Byaki and Terra are proof of that. Plus, it'd be frustrating to get held back by affection when it's my time to kill. You're still saying that. Of course. I'll sacrifice the lives of everyone here if it guarantees my survival. Hajime says, you don't really feel that way, right? You're not that kind of person. That's true. How do we know that that's true, Chet? Every time we got close to calling Pekko out as the killer, who's the one that jumped in and argued every single time? Fuyuhiko. Remember? We'd be like, oh wait, Pekko, was it you? And he'd be like, what the fuck are you guys talking about? Shut up, you don't know anything. It wasn't her. If he really thought of her as a tool, wouldn't he just sit back and be like, ah ha ha, everything's going according to plan. They all think it's Pekko. But no, every time we got closer to pinning down Pekko as the killer, Fuyuhiko would be like, shut the fuck up, bastards. You guys don't know what you're talking about. Because if you were, you wouldn't be hesitating like you are right now. He's hesitating. There's no need to hesitate, young master. Please just tell them the truth. Young master, you were the one that ordered me. I did just as I did because you told me I'm a tool. Fuyuhiko, this could be considered your ultimate choice. Regardless, either way, you'll still lose Pekko. Wow. That's a fucked up thing to say, but it's true, Nagito. No matter what choice he makes, he's going to lose Pekko. Either he gets away with the crime and Pekko gets killed, or he gets killed and he can no longer be with Pekko. No matter what choice he makes, he will lose Pekko. If you insist that you're the killer, just as she said, you can sacrifice us and survive alone. Would you rather reject Pekko and fight alongside us against despair? This, right now, is Fuyuhiko's ultimate decision. Which one will be your hope? Let's hear what you have to say.
Damn it.
Damn, look at him.
Young master, I am finished.
This is what really happened. Notice that the expression on his face is different. In Pekko's version of the story, Fuyuhiko was happy. He had like an evil smile and he was like, yes. But in the reality of the situation, it's much different. Let's check it out. Young master, I'm finished.
You? What the hell did you do? You already know, right? What's going to happen after you kill someone?
I did it because I know. There is no way I can let that happen to you.
So we found out the truth. Pekko didn't do this on Fuyuhiko's behalf. Look it. He was just like, what did you do? He's like, do you realize what you just did? He did not order her to kill Mahiru.
Hey, Pekko. Do you remember what I told you when we first arrived on this island? Our professional relationship doesn't exist on this island. We're just fellow high school students now. You need to run. Got it? Just let me take the fall so you can get away.
Wow. So what really happened, Chet, is Fuyuhiko said, just let me take the fall for this. Get out of here. Let me take this. So that is very telling of Fuyuhiko's character. He was willing to take the rep for this murder.
Young master, that is impossible.
Shut up. I'm ordering you not to worry about me.
There is no way I cannot worry about you. I am my young master's tool. A tool to protect my young master.
I mean, I definitely agree he's a douchebag, but he had feelings for Pekko because they've known each other since they were kids, dude.
Without an owner, a tool serves no purpose.
That's the fucked up thing right now about this. Pekko sees herself as only a tool, but Fuyuhiko obviously sees her as something more than that. In Pekko's eyes, she's just like, I'm just a tool. I'll do anything that Fuyuhiko wants. But she interprets it as, I'm just listening to whatever Fuyuhiko says. But the reason why Fuyuhiko is saying, let's distance ourselves, let's make sure that we don't let anybody know about our relationship, is he doesn't want Pekko to get hurt. He never wanted her in danger. Because he doesn't see her as just a tool.
God damn it, we are done with that crap! Why won't you listen to what I'm saying?
Listen to the emotion in his voice.
Regardless, I will not flee. Besides, I'm fairly certain they'll discover the truth soon enough.
Then why did you?
I have a plan.
A plan?
And her plan was to pretend to be shining or sparkling justice to put the blame on her.
Please do not worry. I promise I will keep my young master alive and return him safely home.
And she said, I have a plan that will return you home safely. And that was to take the rat and get everybody to vote for her.
You idiot. What do you intend to do?
I intend to fulfill my duty as your tool. Now please, go. Hyoko will be waking up soon.
Oh yeah, Hyoko's in the closet the whole time with next to the gummy.
After you leave, I must block the door to the road with Mahiru's body. Hurry.
Oh, that's how Fuyuhiko was able to get out. Fuyuhiko left out the back door before Pekko blocked the door with Mahiru's body. That's how there was no footprints, and he was not able... Because he wouldn't have been able to get through the window. Pekko let him out the back door, then put Mahiru there to block it.
You better run away. Got it? Just forget about me. Forget about the Kuzuryu clan. You better escape.
So how about it, Fuyuhiko? Please, tell me the truth.
Sorry.
I'm sorry, Pekko. I guess I couldn't go through with it after all.
Master.
I'm a disgrace.
Because if that's actually what I have to do to survive, I'd just feel ashamed of myself. It'd mean I can't live without depending on something. I'd just feel disgusted with myself.
Pekko.
He's like, and if I admit that, it means you really are just a tool to me. How many times did I tell you I don't want a tool?
Young master.
Oh my, so this is how it turned out.
Too bad.
And here I thought it would be more brutal and heartless. Man, how disappointing. I don't know, Monokuma, this seems pretty fucked up to me. Which means everything happened thanks to her meddlesome actions. So that's all Monokuma had to hear. Once he realized that Pekko killed Mahiru not under Fuhiko's orders, that confirmed right there that the real killer is Pekko. Because we just found out that Fuhiko never told her to kill Mahiru. She did it of her own free will. So Monokuma's like, that's enough for me. There's no way a human that meddlesome could ever be considered a tool. Damn.
Hey.
Monokuma, you knew all along, didn't you? You knew about what Pekko and Fuhiko discussed.
Jeez.
It's obvious now. I mean, that's why you have a surveillance cameras. You're just having fun, huh? Man, even if it was act of desperation, Pekko's claim was surprisingly interesting. You're actually the first to try to influence the outcome of the trial like that. Too bad, you're definitely the killer. Well, there we go. Looks like Hajime and friends are safe because Pekko, they did vote right. We were able to convince Monokuma that Pekko is the real killer, even if she thinks of herself as only a tool. So it looks like we're not going to be sentenced to death today. However, Pekko will be. Pekko, the tool with a heart, is the killer. Damn. She wanted to die too. But like, not this way. And then Fuhiko's like, Pekko, I'm sorry I couldn't fulfill your request. Even though you did all that to provide me the chance to survive. But I... There's only like 5 minutes left, Taters, because I gotta go to the bathroom too. There's only like... It's gotta be soon. All right, shh. Okay, shh. Pekko says, I had a feeling it would turn out like this. Fuhiko says, huh?
Young master...
You have a kind heart, despite being a Yakuza. That's why you question your position and constantly worry about it. For you to sacrifice someone else just to escape by yourself. So Pekko's like, even if you act like a piece of shit, nobody knows me better than you, and I know that you have a kind heart. I believe that you wouldn't accept this so easily. We've been together ever... That's like the... Look at that smile. That's the first time she ever smiles that way. We've been together ever since we were children. Even a tool would understand that.
What?
Then why?
Even so.
I wanted you to escape. Damn, dude. I wanted to protect you.
Pekko.
I am terribly sorry.
I will not be able to serve by your side until the very end.
Bye.
No, dude, this is fucking sad. Fuck, dude, how many lives can Monokuma ruin? I'm sorry for what I've done to you all, too. It may be a selfish request, but please forgive my young master. All that, like, she wanted, and her last thing is like, can you guys please forgive Fuhiko? That's her last request, is please forgive Fuhiko.
And please do not cause a senseless killing such as this. Ever again.
And she asks everybody, please make sure that something so such a stupid killing never happens again. Hajime's like, of course. That will do, Monokuma. Why don't you start it already?
I will never feel despair.
She said, I will never feel despair. I'm fully prepared to die.
So cool.
Will you be able to maintain that composure till the very end? People who act as proud as you always shed tears of despair in the end. Now then, let's begin.
Young master Fuhiko.
She says, Fuhiko, please let me make one final selfish request.
So?
Didn't I tell you not to call me young master? I want you to remember the tool. Pekko Pekko Yama, who used to stand beside you. I'd like it if you remembered that. That's all. She just wants to be remembered, dude. That's it. She's like, don't forget. How many times do you have to keep... I don't need any tools. And you did say that. Let's begin. Punishment time. So he's like, chop chop, come on. It's punishment time.
Jeez.
Why don't you get it yet?
Thrills, chills, kills.
Time for the ultimate swordsman, Pekko Pekko Yama.
Right.
Here we go. This is fucking breaking my heart. You stayed by my side all this time. Why don't you get it?
Now then, I prepared a very special punishment.
I never needed a sword or a shield.
I never needed a tool. So, you didn't need to become a tool.
Let's give it everything we've got!
You just needed to be yourself.
You didn't need to be a tool. You just needed to be yourself. All Fuyuhiko wanted, Pekko, he didn't want a bodyguard, he didn't want a tool. He just wanted you to be the way that you were.
I never wanted a tool. I just wanted you. Only you.
Fuck me, man. I never wanted a tool. I just wanted you. Only you.
Young master?
Why? Why couldn't you understand? We've always been together ever since we were kids.
Let's go! It's punishment time!
Please, Pekko. Don't go! I need you! Don't leave me!
Wow, dude. Fuck. And this big fucking asshole, he starts crying. This big piece of shit said he was gonna fucking kill everybody. Look at her, he's like, I need you.
Young master?
And she's crying too, Jesus.
Young master?
Jesus Christ. Oh my god, dude! This is the most despair anybody's ever felt ever. This is beyond despair. Now Fuyuhiko has to, he finally like told Pekko how he felt, and now he has to like watch her fucking be executed by the Mono Samurais. The one woman army. Damn, look at her, we get to see her fight. Holy shit, she's fighting him. Sick. No, Fuyuhiko, what are you doing? No, Fuyuhiko! No, Fuyuhiko got in the way of the blade! No, fuck! Oh my god! No! Oh, fuck! Well, now Fuyuhiko and Pekko both executed. Holy shit. The last thing Pekko did before she died was, so Fuyuhiko ran in the way and Pekko was like so angry and she sliced the Monokuma, not knowing that right behind the Monokuma was Fuyuhiko. Then at the end, they were both fucking put down, dude. So the last thing Pekko did was accidentally fucking kill her master and then died. Even Fuyuhiko? Holy shit! This should not be allowed. People dying so easy, falling like dominoes. Is there no end to Monokuma's fucked up world? Welcome everybody to Monokuma's wild ride. Buckle in, pieces of shit. This is only case 2 of 6. This can't be. This is a lie, right? Pekko! Fuyuhiko!
Such a waste.
For heaven's sake, this is just the worst. Jeez, what a waste. This conclusion, what a waste. This is why she should have discussed it with me. It was supposed to be a clash between two hopes, but it was crushed into something so unpalatable. So Monokuma took all the hope. He's like, nobody's gonna win. He's like, fuck y'all. It was actually Fuyuhiko's fault. Fuyuhiko tried to, don't interfere with a punishment. You know, Fuyuhiko tried to stop Pekko's punishment and then ended up getting killed himself.
Oh.
Still talking about that? What the hell's wrong with you? Aren't you pissed that two of your friends just got killed?
Such despair.
I am pissed. And I even feel sad and hopeless. But still.
Isn't that right?
It's gonna be alright. This despair is worthless. It's just a ladder to a bright, shining future that awaits us. The higher the ladder, the brighter we can shine. That's the unmistakable truth.
Hmm.
Calling me a ladder, huh? You say some pretty interesting things. In a way, your misguided thoughts of what hope should be kinda remind me of him. Oh my god, another fucking foreshadowing drop? Monokuma just says, in a way, your misguided thoughts of what hope should be reminds me of him. Who the fuck does it remind you of, Monokuma? I don't really understand what you're saying.
Listen carefully.
I shall make a declaration. We will definitely destroy you. The hopes of all the Ultimates here will definitely, completely, utterly destroy you. There won't even be a strand of cotton left when we're done with you. That's your future. How much longer are you planning to say such stupid things? Don't you understand? Even Fuyuhiko died, you know. Monomi's pissed. Not yet. It's still not over yet, Snake. He's still alive. Nani?
What?
Everyone.
Fuyuhiko's still alive.
You serious?
Fuyuhiko? Frantically, we rushed over to Fuyuhiko's side. Oh my god, he's fucked up though. Pekko slashed him so hard. Yeah, in both English and Japanese. And they're both the ultimate lucky student, Shin. Sit on that one for a while.
He's still breathing.
He's still breathing. That's good.
Is he gonna be okay?
He don't look okay.
Do something. Hey, you need to save him. Hey.
I'm trying.
Mikan's trying, dude. Holy shit. Well, serves him right.
You're so stupid.
Are you filled at hope at the thought of saving her yourself? That's why you ended up like that.
Stupid,
what are you so laid back about? You need to hurry up and save him.
I don't believe it.
Monokuma's like, why would I ever save him? This is way more funny.
What the heck?
Why did I burn my precious calories just to save some Yakuza scum?
That's wrong.
It's your duty to save him. It's written in the school trip rules. Oh shit, Monomi's throwing down the rule book. Yep, it says, if the Blackened is found out, they and they alone will be executed. Fuyuhiko should not be allowed to be executed. He does follow the rules. No magic stick. She's like, you said in your rules, Monokuma, that only the Blackened and only the Blackened will be executed. What are you gonna say about that, Monokuma? I guess I have no choice.
Fine.
There's no way I can violate a rule, even if it's me.
So...
Fine then, I'll save him. Really?
Like...
I was actually gonna do that all along, so I already prepared for this. Prepared? And that's when it happened. A siren began ringing from out of nowhere. And gradually grew closer and closer. Oh shit, dude, it's the Monobalance! How a what? Ambulance?
Just leave the rest to me, Dr. Killgood!
Dr. Killgood! Boop, boop, boop!
Dr. Killgood, you've already killed your patient!
What the fuck, dude?
We gotta get this patient to the Monokuma Hospital ER and get him under 24-hour observation stat!
Let's go! Let's put him...
So, I'll see you later!
Oh, buckle up, Harper. I'm streaming so much this game because it just is we gotta keep playing till the end. Alright, after that, the ambulance containing Monokuma and Fuyuko vanished from our sight. Is it really gonna be okay to leave this to Monokuma?
Damn it.
Can't be helped. It's not like there's any other way.
Perhaps.
He's gonna be fine. He's probably gonna get better and come back to us again. You're right. He's definitely gonna come back and talk a lot of smack as if nothing happened. Alright. Why do we have to wait for him? I mean, he caused Mahiru's death, you know.
However,
we must put that aside since Pekko's already been punished. Or else we'll not be able to advance forward.
Fall, my tears.
There are no second chances in life. We cannot return to what has already transpired. There is no other way than to move forward, like an arrow of light piercing through the darkness.
Things aren't as exciting if a shit stirrer like him ain't around. I didn't realize it, but I was wishing for that too. From the bottom of my heart, I really wanted him to return. Fuyuko, I don't want anyone else to be a sacrifice. And so, the clash trial ended. Man, oh man, what a fucking ride. It feels like we live in a different reality from when we first entered this trial. Remember when we were just looking around the beach house? I feel like so much happened this trial. So much happened. But we still can't see the real ending that we want yet. When that finally arrives, what will have happened to us by then? No matter where I look, no matter what possibilities I look for, I can't see our future. Not even a speck. As if we were in a boat floating unreliably in a vast dark sea. We were just left there, alone. Only one word could explain our situation. Despair. We couldn't find a more suitable word than that. Oh, what the fuck, dude? 15 days remain. 15 days and 10 hours remain. Oh, what's Monomi doing here?
You can see it, right? You can see this countdown too?
Oh, what the fuck? Okay, I'm gonna shut up.
Four people are already gone. We took our time preparing the hope fragments, but now we're no longer able to gather them.
Nobody knows, Taters. We have nobody has any idea what the fuck that timer even is.
Honestly, I'm not so sure anymore. Whether it's better if we let them leave this island, or if we shouldn't let them escape.
Onomi says, I don't even know anymore. Is it better if we leave them on this island or let them escape? Monomi says, no matter what happens, if we allow this countdown to reach zero, that guy will probably take over our plan's final stage. What the fuck does that mean? So it sounds like Monomi had a plan, but if we allow this countdown to reach zero, somebody will take over the plan's final stage. What lies beyond that is the resurrection of the ultimate despair.
And the continuation of the biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history.
The continuation.
That cannot be allowed. We must prevent that by any means necessary. Even if we have to pay the ultimate price, I will definitely prevent it by any means. Everything is for the sake of a future filled with hope.
Everything for the sake of a future filled with hope. Holy shit, that's a good-ass fucking chapter or case if you tell me. Some people think. Some people like case one more. But for me, dude, that was better than case one for me. Case one had some crazy shit, don't get me wrong, with Nagito, but that one tops it for me. I don't care, I'm sorry. The Nagito reveal was big, but this had a lot. I mean, you had the school ruins, you had the whole case, the secrets, the mystery. There is just so much more, dude. I like Case 2. The Twilight Syndrome murder game, I think Case 2 trumps Case 1 for me. Some people really, really like Case 1 because of the whole Nagito shit, but for me, Case 2, that's it. And we got Pekko's sword. All right. Let's, as they say in Brooklyn, skippity-doo-dah, skippity-day, save the game. Who's gonna... Oh, shit, there's mystery words? Well, it looks like we're gonna find out what happens next on the next episode of the Milky Finishers Play Danganronpa.